On the biggest of stages come the biggest of moments, and it doesn't get any bigger than an Olympic gold medal in men's ice hockey. Gangneung Hockey Center, the venue, the Olympic athlete from Russia squad will contend for gold, looking to end a 26-year gold medal drought. Their last gold medal was in 1992. They will face Team Germany. A surprise to everyone except for their fans and their coaching staff and the roster. A magnificent competition for Team Germany. They did not compete in Sochi 2014. They were 11th in Vancouver. But this is a team that has upset both of the medalists from Sochi. They have beaten Sweden, the silver medalist, and Canada, the gold medalist from 4 years ago. And this is going to be some kind of battle between the OAR and Germany. The crowd anticipating what will be a special moment for both the Olympic athlete from Russia squad and Germany. The bronze medal went to Canada, but now we turn our attention to a closing of the curtains, if you will, on what has been a magnificent competition. And for Germany, history, they have never played for a gold medal at the Olympics, and for the OAR, they're looking for their first gold since 1992.
Olympic athletes from Russia, a 4-1 record. They play one less game by right of coming through, qualifying top seed in their group after preliminary round, as we look at the teams making their way off. And there are the OAR in their signature red, as you might expect, the big red machine. And not since 1992. That was the post-Soviet Union era when they won a gold medal. That was in Albertville, France. Have they gone to the top of the podium at the Olympic Games? And a challenge now for Germany. Where will Germany go in this game? Are they content already to have won the shiniest medal ever in the history of their nation in ice hockey? In 1932 and 1976, they win bronze. And already in this game in 2018, they've won silver. But is there a magical story here, something akin to what the Americans referred to as the miracle on ice in 1980 in Lake Placid, when they, in fact, as a number of college players, took on the mighty USSR and took them down in the semifinal and ultimately went on to win that gold medal in Lake Placid, those home games for the Americans. For this German story here, is it as big as that? You're darn right it is. If they were to take out the OAR here at this stage right here, this is the stuff of Olympic legends.
They have won four straight games to be here, and three of those wins have come in extra time. So if you're the OAR coming up against this surprising yet magnificent German squad, you want to get it done in 60 minutes, because if it goes to extra time or a shootout, no doubt Germany will have a lot of belief they can get it done. And there is the biggest of victories in their history, perhaps Sweden, a 4-3 win for Germany in the quarterfinals, and a magnificent effort against the defending champions Canada in the semifinals.
Marcus Sturm and his comments about those first couple games for Germany. They were defeated the first couple games in this tournament. And he said they learned from those and they got better. It helped to make them better in a better group, they said, in the preliminary round, playing against better teams. And that helped them to improve. And as they improved, they adjusted, they were successful. And that's got them through to where they are in this gold medal game.
Very confident looking dressing room you see down at the end there, Ilya Kovalchuk. He's had a magnificent competition, 5 goals and 2 assists. And a very confident bunch on the other side of the puck. Why not? Germany with wins over Sweden and Canada. It started with a big 2-1 win in the final game of the group stage in a shootout over Norway. They went on to a 2-1 playoff positioning win in overtime over Switzerland. And then, of course, the big win over Sweden in overtime and then against Canada.
You know who that is? That is Jim Pack of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Stanley Cup winner, Chison Pak, the leader of the Korean men's and women's program in these Olympic Games in PyeongChang. He's enjoying this now, getting an opportunity as a spectator, as we are inside of 5 minutes before the puck is to drop. And you see the pageantry, both the Russian fans and the German fans. Those hats are special. As tick of the clock, we are counting down.
When the German squad beat Switzerland in the playoff positioning game, it was Yannick Seidenberg, the hero. And in the quarterfinal win against Sweden in overtime, it was a magnificent effort by Reimer. They have been unbelievable in knocking off some of the top seeds in extra time. But you look there at the Olympic athlete from Russia squad. What a competition it has been for Nikita Gusev. 2 goals and 6 assists. Probably the most valuable player for Germany is goaltender Danny Ostenbürken.
He has to be the best player on the ice today for Germany. It's yes, if you match the forwards for Germany against the Olympic athletes from Russia, the Olympic athletes from Russia are of greater quality. Maybe at this moment in time that the German team are playing well enough to be successful in this game, this is true. But Danny Ostenbürken is going to have to be the number one player on the ice for Germany for them to have any chance of going through the OAR to claim a gold medal in this 60-minute affair, or maybe more.
Koshechkin will get the start. He has been sublime between the pipes. Koshechkin with a 1.08 goals against average and a 9.51 save percentage for the OAR. They are the home team. They wear their dark red jerseys. They will have last change. That will help Oleg Znarek out. Interesting point on both sides of the puck. All 25 players for the OAR from the KHL, all 25 players for Team Germany from the DEL. So cohesion and familiarity up and down both rosters.
Well, that's not a coincidence. The fact that these two nations have their national programs with their personnel playing their club hockey in their respective countries. That's entirely a huge reason why both of these nations are here in this. And the reason for that is, as you just said, there is synergy. There's crossover. There's an understanding of what you're representing. You're not flying in here as a tournament team from all corners of the globe to compete at the Olympic Games and to put on the best show possible. You have been building in your psyche and in the national mindset in preparation for this. As you look at Koshechkin with the great numbers, 1.08 goals against average, a mountain of a man, 6'7", 240 pounds. Ostenbürken, 6'2", you know, a normal size for a goalkeeper in ice hockey, 2.54, those are good numbers, 90.37, they're good, but they're not spectacular. He's got to be spectacular to beat the OAR today.
Pavel Datsyuk, the captain of the Olympic athlete from Russia squad, 5 assists in the competition. That gives him 20 career assists at Olympic Games, and this is 5th turnout at the Olympics. The captain, Marcel Gotch, also has been magnificent for Germany.
The magic man, Pavel Datsyuk, is as good an all-round player that the world currently has playing in the game, and possibly ever, as now Marcel Gotch. He's got wonderful pedigree as well from the National Hockey League. In my mind, he's not Pavel Datsyuk, but that doesn't probably matter. But if you want to watch one player, number 13, and of course then Kovalchuk, number 71, the all-time Russian leader in Olympic scoring on the ice, was maybe going to go and play in the National Hockey League this year, stayed back, and here as we look at the referees, the gold medal was always in store in what they were aiming for this Russian program.
Mark Lemelin of the USA, Alexei Rantala of Finland, the referees Jimmy Dahman of Sweden and Sakari Suominen of Finland on the lines, and that's a nice honor. Players, coaches, all the rosters, honored to be a part of a gold medal game. Well, if you're one of the referees named to the gold medal game, you are one of the top officials on the planet, so a nice tip of the cap to the referees. There's Oleg Znarek, 2014, a world championship gold medal. 5th year as the head coach of the OAR. Marco Sturm in his 3rd year behind the bench for Germany. What a job he has done. Captain of Team Germany at the 2010 Olympics, Marco Sturm. And there is Gusev, 2 goals and 6 assists, leading the OAR in points. The leading point getter for Germany is Patrick Hager, 3 goals and 3 assists. He has been phenomenal.
Germany, their players have to play the best of their ability in this hockey game for them to claim gold. OAR have to be very good, but they've got deeper talent.
Andronov versus Hager, and we are underway in the biggest of games, the gold medal game, OAR versus Germany. And I don't know if it's significant for Team Germany, but they wore these gold jerseys against Canada in the semifinals. Wearing the gold jerseys again here in the gold medal game, well, who knows?
Possibly nerves. Germany within 4 seconds, take an icing call. They're in their defensive zone now.
Hager and Andronov will reset. Andronov with a face-off win, and straight away, Ilya Kovalchuk. Nice set piece from the OAR. Andrinov with a faceoff win, and Kovalchuk, who has 5 goals in the competition, looking for more. Well, tripping call straight away. The discipline is important in this, as both teams are pretty good on the power play.
They got a little bit lucky here, Germany. They might get a let off. They take 4 seconds in, they take an icing call, then they're in their own defensive zone. It looked like maybe they had taken the penalty themselves, but it's going to go against OAR, as just reaching back here, Andrinov, and going down the German defenseman. They've got to just settle down here now, Germany, and just let the puck do the work.
23.1% on the power play for Germany. 6 power play goals in the competition. The penalty kill for the OAR is the best penalty kill in PyeongChang, 95%. They have allowed just 1 power play goal against. So a good power play against a great penalty kill. Germany with some early momentum if they can get in and attack on this power play. You see they're 6 for 26.
How impressive that David Wolf is on this power play to start this game for Germany. He'll be in front of the net.
Masek has 2 power play goals in the competition for Germany. He dumps it in for Cahoon. At times in the semifinal, Cahoon was the best player on the ice. Seidenberg, the hero against Switzerland, gets it to Dominic Cahoon. Cahoon back to Maurer. Maurer with the little feather pass to Seidenberg. Seidenberg's shot gets through, but it's Nesterov. Good body in front.
Just to qualify about the remark about David Wolf, he was knocked out of the game in the semifinal on a hit from the Canadian player Brule. We thought he had suffered a concussion. He came back incredibly, and here he is, restored what looks to be to full health. He will not want to miss this moment.
David Wolf is a tough, tough individual. A hard-nosed player, plays the game the right way. 842 penalty minutes in his DEL career, but also a very useful player offensively and on the forecheck.
There's the magic man, just ever so calmly sweeping that puck down the ice and making Germany have to reload on the man advantage.
Ehrhoff to Hager. Hager gets it across to Reimer. Reimer was the hero in overtime against Sweden. He just pokes at that, but it's up and over the glass with 46 seconds remaining in Andrinov's tripping penalty.
A couple decent touches early on his power play from Germany. You can see by the way they maneuver the puck just how they're feeling about things. They made some quick plays. Although they're being closed down time and space by the OAR defense, they were ready for it.
Sherikov and Cahoon. Cahoon with the faceoff win. Almost too clean, that faceoff win. Ripped it between Masek and Seidenberg. Here is Yannick Seidenberg. Seidenberg, 770 career DEL games played. Here's Cahoon. Cahoon trying to tap it back to Masek. Masek in the corner. Masek hit by Gavrikov. Masek takes a hit to make a play, and it goes back to Cahoon. Cahoon to Seidenberg. Seidenberg gets the shot through. Tipped in front by Wolf. Wolf with the net front presence and a great play.
The most important part is the shot gets through. So many of the shots are getting blocked anymore. To get it through, particularly on the power play, when the defensive structure for OAR can change its angle. They did well there, Germany. That's impressive.
Hordler to Kink. Good stop by Kwaszczykin as well through traffic. At 6'7", when he goes down, he still takes up most of the net. The power play is over. 0-for-1 on the man advantage, and a good penalty kill by the OAR. Kalinin with the shot. Kalinin trying to sweep it through the legs. He goes back to Nesterov. Nesterov's shot. He had traffic in front as Kovalchuk trying to take away the eyes of Austin Birkin. Kovalchuk works it back into the middle, and it will be picked up by Kink ahead for Newbels.
Even this play there from Germany exiting their own zone, they didn't panic. They made sure they maneuvered the puck from one man to the other, only leaving it for a German player to have body position on it and then advance it into the OAR zone. Those little things are indicative of this German side believing they can play this game for gold. They're not just here running through the motions to get silver. Watch this shot here from the blue line. Seidenberg, just a little hitch, a couple step overs to the left-hand side, and he finds a shooting lane through, and Kazetskin makes the save. He sees it, but so much traffic in front.
Zubarev up the left side looking for Gusev. Here's Hager. Hager has had an all-star type tournament for Team Germany. 3 goals and 3 assists for the assistant captain. Here's Kirill Kaprizov. Kaprizov up the left side, angled off by Krupp. Krupp back into Yakovlev, and Yakovlev is run over by Schutz. Good forecheck by Schutz.
Smart play from the Germans so far. They've been aggressive, they've closed down, they've been quick on the puck. They force an icing here now against by the OAR. It's nothing to necessarily get overly excited about, but the opening 5 minutes for Germany were going to be a telling of the tale as to where they really feel themselves in this match.
Oleg Snarek, very experienced coach. He's also the head coach of SKA St. Petersburg. There are 15 SKA St. Petersburg players up and down this roster. They have a lot of that cohesion we talked about off the top. But so far, Germany playing physical on the forecheck with those layers that Marco Sturm likes to play with. Very North American style, trying to frustrate the OAR. Here's Gusev. Gusev twirls back, works his way down the half wall, and that gets intercepted by Maurer. Maurer, good defensive play. And here's Christian Ehrhoff, the assistant captain. One goal and one assist in the competition. Ehrhoff, 789 NHL games played in his career. He has been a key cog in the wheel for Germany at this PyeongChang Olympics. Here's Ehrhoff right on cue. Ehrhoff gives it away, and it's a quick shot by Zubarev. Here's Mosiakin. Mosiakin right on target, and Austin Birkin pressed into action.
The sequence before, Germany made three passes and out, and it was so clean and so fine, I was wanting to comment on it. Ehrhoff makes the right play here, but the service is not exact. If you make a loose play and an unaligned pass like that one was right there, it could very well be in the back of your net before you blink your eyes.
Sergei Mosiak in the KHL's all-time leading point getter. The only KHL player with more than 600 points. Good quick shot there by Mosiak. And Mosiak had that face-off come back between the legs. Here's Seidenberg.
And another indication there of the stick strength from Germany right there, taking it away from the OAR player. It wasn't a penalty. He just lifted the stick, showed his intention, and I think OAR caught out by it because they didn't have a good grip on their stick.
15:41 to go, first period, no score, and if you're Team Germany, you'll be happy with that. They thought maybe they'd have to weather a storm, but I think on the other side, the OAR are weathering that forecheck and that net front presence from Germany. Marco Sturm, the head coach, Dallaire and Kunas, the assistants. Marco Sturm has done a great job with this program.
Oh, has he ever. And the way he celebrated the goal from Plakta in a semifinal, to me, said everything. Against Canada, it was an incredible play, taken against maybe kind of from nowhere. And he stood there after as everybody else celebrated, and he didn't move an inch. And basically what that tells me is, gentlemen, we're going to celebrate like we've been here, and we know we belong to be here.
It's a great attitude. Act like you should be there. Act like you should score, and good things happen. Here's Wolf. Wolf to Gotch. The captain, Gotch, tries to get a shot off. It's into the shin pads of Zub. Here's Kablukov to Telegin. Telegin, one on two. Telegin with the shot, and Austin Birkin got the blocker across just in time.
Austin Birkin looks comfortable so far in goal for Germany. Both sides do. I don't see any indication here that anybody's overwhelmed by the moment. It's going to be a good hockey game as we watch the service inside here, and Telegin just gets one off. Top of the circles, take your chances. Austin Birkin, no, tracks it well. Comes across, blockers it, up out of play.
It's a gold puck. In a gold medal game, the pucks were blue throughout the competition. They have that special gold puck, and there's another souvenir for a fan. Danny Austin Birkin, he knows how to win. Three times a DEL champion in the domestic league in Germany, so the occasion won't ruffle his feathers. He knows how to get the job done.
Yeah, he does. Just in reference to those pucks there, you think a gold medal is a big deal to get? It's almost as big a deal to get as a gold puck.
Kovalchuk trying to get one step closer there, and Kovalchuk ripped it low and away, blocker side. Voinov came in. Dumped it, and Voinov has had a magnificent tournament as well. Plus +7 in the competition.
Oh,
Fausser high into the body there, and Fausser turned back.
Fortunate there. That was a German player who played it off a player. I think it was Fausser in front, took that up in the head area. And fortunate that it wasn't maybe to the open side, maybe in the mouth area, but it just jumps up into the bench as we get a good look across the international flavor that is in Olympic Games.
Gangneung Hockey Center, a beautiful facility. The volunteers, the staff, everything first class. And the players have enjoyed it. The ice has been great, and this is some kind of final. The OAR versus Germany. No score yet in this gold medal game. PyeongChang 2018. Here's Gusev. Gusev to Kaprizov. Kaprizov tries to go across to Datsyuk, but that was deflected away by a good stick by Boyle. Hager chasing it down against Kisilevich. Hager into the corner. Hager turns away from Kisilevich, goes to Schutz. Schutz puts on the brakes, gets away from Datsyuk. Here comes Schutz. Schutz turns and fires through the blue paint, looking for the tip from Hager. Hager going to the front of the net, as has Masek. Masek and Hager nearly recipients there. Here's Kaprizov with a shot, and another good stop by Austin Birkin.
It was inside the post, that shot from Kaprizov. Birkin had to make the save. Austin Birkin gets his shoulder to it. He did very well to square up and to take away that angle and get big at the top of the blue paint.
Ehrhoff gets it inside the line. Zub will backtrack for the OAR. Shots on goal, OAR 4, Germany 1. Zub goes right up the gut looking for the stick of Sherikov. Sherikov got a piece of it but couldn't control. Austin Birkin to Muller. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg happy to just dump and chase. Simple hockey from Germany so far. Not trying to match skill, but trying to match hard work.
And equally for Germany, they've not taken a penalty so far. It's not been an issue for them, but it can be an issue when the stage is too big for you. They are proving that it's not. They are able to keep their emotions in check.
Prohorkin wheels up the left side to Mosiakin. Mosiakin fanned on that pass forward for Sherikov, and Seidenberg just dumps it back in. Zubarev will glide in behind the OAR goal line, tucked in behind Koshechkin. Zubarev up the middle looking for Telegin. Telegin kept his feet moving around Hordler. Here's Telegin. Telegin turns and fires. Grigorenko and Kablikov in front trying to take away the eyes of Austin Birkin. Good hit by Wolf. Wolf trying to staple Gavrikov. Physical start to the game on both sides of the puck. Here's Reimer, and Reimer just guides it out into the neutral zone. 12 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in period one. No score between the OAR in Germany. Telegin trying to get it ahead to Grigorenko. Knocked down by Gotch. Here's Wolf. Wolf goes all the way back to Hordler. Hordler up the middle. Good little play by Nubles. Nubles trying to outweigh everybody. Gets by Nesterov and goes back to Boyle. Boyle takes a big hit check from Nesterov. Here's Fausser. Fausser turns and fires. The stick in the blocker coming down from Koshechkin. Well, then gloved the shot from Erhoff. Great sequence around the net for Germany.
Koshechkin, because he's such a big man, he'll go down to his knees. He makes a good glove save there. Neither team have been able to get on the scoreboard yet. We're scoreless, OAR and Germany in the first period. This is a play quick up the ice from OAR, right on the tape of Kaprizov. And from the dot there, he's got a look to the far side of goal. He tries to go across the face as he receives this one in perfect motion. He's got the ability to beat Austin Birkin from there. It was Austin Birkin, though, with the left shoulder that just squares it out to make sure that doesn't get a chance to get past.
What a pass from Gusev. That's why Gusev leads the KHL in assists. That's why he leads the competition in assists, and then a good stop by Koshechkin.
Every bit of the play so far for both teams, but more so we will note it for Germany, because Germany are the underdog in the situation. We have to say that. It's the truth. They simply don't have the world ranking. They simply don't have the history. And in fairness, they just don't, on paper, have the same team as OAR. But right now, they are playing it straight up.
Andronov draws the puck across for Kovalchuk. Plakta trying to lift the stick of Kovalchuk. Plakta has had a magnificent competition, especially in the knockout stages. Nubles stripped by Zubarev. Zubarev ahead for Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk. Andronov. Andronov sidesteps Erhoff. Andronov back to Zub. Zub for Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk snakes his way along the boards to Kalinin. Kalinin played for the New Jersey Devils last year. He's a big body presence and works well with Kovalchuk. Here's Zubarev. Zubarev gains the line, thought he had, and Plakta blocks that dump in. Here's Schutz. Schutz gains momentum, comes right up the middle to Hagger. Hagger to Schutz. Schutz can't get the shot away, dumps it in behind the goal line, and Hagger finishes his hit off. Seidenberg trying to keep it deep. Yakovlev trying to find the tape of Kaprizov, but that's an icing call against the OAR.
What you've seen so far, a couple of times, yes, they got the play up to Kaprizov for that shot against the German keeper, but they haven't had the speed to the neutral zone, and they've not been able to link the passes up consistently to create offensive waves of attack against Germany so far.
Face off to the left of Koshechkin. Datsyuk versus Hagger. Kisilevich, good face-off win by the magic man, Pavel Datsyuk. Gusev doesn't gain the line, though, and back-to-back icing calls against the OAR.
It's a small thing, but it's a noticeable thing from the OAR. That's not their game, going back and taking face-offs in their own zone.
Shows the pressure and the layers of the forecheck by Germany. You see the fat lip by Fauser there. Fauser blocked a shot earlier in the knockout stage with his face. So that's what Germany are willing to do. Block shots with their faces to get to this point. And you know that at this point, they've got nothing to lose. They're willing to block shots, do what it takes to try and wrestle a gold medal around their necks. Here's Gusev to Yakovlev. Yakovlev takes a hit from Hager. Good hit by Hager there. Here's Datsyuk against Seidenberg. Shoots, chopping at the stick of Datsyuk. Yakovlev. Yakovlev with the shot. It was wide. He's looking for a deflection in front, but Datsyuk was late to the party. Here's Datsyuk. Datsyuk being watched by Jonas Muller. Datsyuk turns and fires, deflected by Kaprizov in behind the goal line. We approach the halfway mark of the first period. No score between the OAR and Germany. Shots on goal, OAR 4, Germany 3. Here's Kaprizov. Nikita Gusev. Nikita Gusev, 2 goals and 6 assists in the competition. We talked about it. He leads the KHL in assists with 40 this year for SKA. Seidenberg can't move the puck. It's a good play by Barabanov. Barabanov trying to get away from Gotch. Barabanov pulled down. The OAR bench screaming at the officials for a penalty. The officials say play on, and Germany just dump it out. That's some good pressure from the OAR on that shift.
That was the smartest bit of body positioning and forechecking from OAR so far, as Prohorkin. He was dynamic in a game earlier in his tournament against USA. We haven't seen a whole lot of him since. But to separate the man from the puck and to get him on the wrong side of it, it was a play quickly out from OAR, which could have put the first goal in the game and a quick sequence there.
9:46 remaining in period one. Gotch versus Andronov. Faceoff so important in the defensive zone, and Gotch has been pretty good in that regard, but Andronov won it back cleanly, but he split the defenseman. Zub chases it back. Zub to Kovalchuk, Kovalchuk back to Zub. Artem Zub leaves it for Ilya Kovalchuk, winding up with speed. 31 goals in the KHL this season for Kovalchuk, 13 of them on the power play. Here's Hordler. Hordler tries to get it out, got it to the line, no further. Zub with a good pinch, kept it in, but Hordler will try the same thing again. And once again, it's Zub keeping it in. Followed up by Cahoon. Here's Yashin Elitz. Elitz drops it for Cahoon, but a good stick by Zub. Zub having a real good shift on that left point for OAR. Kovalchuk around the horn for Andronov. Andronov into the neutral zone, just gains the line, tries to dump it in, but 3 goal shirts across that blue line as Germany stack the blue line and make any sort of entries difficult for OAR. Here's Hordler. Cahoon. Matthias Plakta. Plakta with a nice little flip and release there. He flipped it up to his own stick and tried to tuck it in low, and then it's followed up by Cahoon. 2 lovely looks at goal there from Germany, but they missed the target.
That play there from Plakta is something you might see from Ronaldo, just to flip it through 2 defenders and pick it up on the other side in football.
It's almost a lacrosse move there to have that ability to lift the puck up and try and swat it out of midair. Fantastic skills by Plakta. Plakta had a goal and an assist in the semifinal against Canada. Here's Telegin, Gavrikov, Kiselevich. Kiselevich has Grigorenko and Kablukov in front. Here is Kablukov. Penalty coming up against Germany as Kablukov kept his feet moving. It will be the first power play of the game for the OAR. No score, OAR and Germany, and the OAR going to the power play here in the first period.
OAR had an opportunity to shoot the puck here, and they made a D-to-D pass, and time I'm thinking that's an unusual let-off from OAR. Thought they should have taken the shot. Anyhow, they assert themselves down low here, and Erhoff, with just a little bit of a can opener, puts the stick in between the arms, the body, and that's enough there nowadays to get yourself a call. And is this something that he's going to regret? Because this, an opportunity for OAR on the power play, is not an invitation you want to extend.
The OAR have been good on the power play, 29.4% in the competition. Germany's penalty kill, they've allowed 6 power play goals against, 77.8% on the PK, so this could be a dangerous moment and maybe a turning point for the OAR.
I tell you, look at the eyes of OAR right now. I'm not telling you that they're nervous, but they don't know what's going on out here right now in the opening 12 minutes.
Face off to the left of Austin Birkin. Datsyuk. Datsyuk won the draw, but Plakta boxed out, and Nubles pounced, and Nubles dumps it up and all the way down. Good job. Good example there. Even if you lose the face-off, you can make something positive happen.
It's a fantastic start to a penalty kill. It's exactly what Germany want to execute.
Kaprizov to Gusev. Gusev to Datsu. Datsu to Nesterov. Nesterov down low. Kaprizov tries to walk in on the backhand, but Austin Birkin closed down the five hole. Here's Gusev to Datsu. Gusev wants to go back to the point. Good stick by Nubles. He nearly deflected that away from Mosiakin, but Mosiakin reads and reacts well, gets it to Datsuk. Here's Mosiakin. Mosiakin with the shot. Turned aside by Austin Birkin, and Nubles goes down on his belly to try and poke that over the line. Datsuk, though, took away his time and space and wins the puck. Here's Nesterov. Nesterov to Gusev. Gusev can thread that puck through the eye of a needle. He goes back to Mosiakin. Mosiakin got it by the outstretched stick of Nubles. Nubles having a good job on the penalty kill here. Gusev, far left side. Gusev. Gusev waits for Krupp to go down. Kaprizov with the shot. Datsuk with the rebound. Two good saves from Austin Birkin.
World-class saves at the most important of times.
Here's Mosiakin. Kaprizov and Datsuk go close. Here's Datsuk. He owns the right side of the ice on the power play, but he gives it up to Gotch there. Gotch. Right there, Germany bending a bit, but not breaking. An important goaltending from Austin Birkin.
And most importantly, four new defenders on the ice for Germany.
Fresh legs over the boards. 20 seconds remaining in the power play for the OAR. 29.4% on the power play coming into this game for the Olympic athlete from Russia squad. Germany, they'd like to be tighter on the PK, 77.8%, but so far so good on this one. But Kalinin swoops in. Kalinin back to Voinov. Voinov just tap dancing to keep that puck in. Erhoff sprints out of the penalty box. Power play is over, but pressure remains. 0 for 1 on the man advantage, but the OAR keep it deep. Good job on the penalty kill from Germany. Here's Barabanov trying to get away from Boyle. Barabanov back to Voinov. Voinov holds it up, goes across the blue line to Gavrikov. Here's Ilya Kovalchuk. 5 goals and 2 assists in this competition so far. Gets stripped right there by Darryl Boyle. And what a moment it was for Darryl Boyle when Germany eliminated Canada. Darryl Boyle, born in Canada, grew up playing hockey in Canada. A thrill to eliminate Canada.
What a moment it was for Darryl Boyle, just making a measured, weighted clearance to the puck after they'd been in their own defensive zone for over 2 minutes and then went back to 5-on-5 that Silverhelm did. That type of play, that little thing right there from Germany, those are the reasons why they're still in a scoreless game right now.
Telegin and Kablikov, like wrecking balls into the corner. Schutz and Jonas Muller bravely trying to defend, trying to move that puck out of the corner, and it shoots. What a play by Schutz. Got it up to Hagerin, relieving the pressure against two of the bigger wingers for the OAR. Kablikov and Telegin. Masek with the shot. Seidenberg in front. Seidenberg couldn't pull the trigger there, but Masek has a real knack of getting pucks through. Masek now with the back check, trying to take away the time and space of Sherikov. Here's Seidenberg, less than 5 minutes to go in the opening stanza. OAR out shooting Germany 8-5. Both teams 0-for-1 on the power play. Yakovlev couldn't get the puck in deep, and a good clearance by Seidenberg.
The most important and most impressive part of that last shift is Austin Birkin has his hands full here. Is Seidenberg is down low in front of OAR's goal. There's 4 German players down there, and they're able to get back and not get caught on an odd man rush against by OAR breaking in transition.
Great back check by Masek as well. Good point. Here's Cahoon. They have to hustle. They have to play all 3 zones. Here's Cahoon. In deep for Moritz Muller. Muller tries the hard angle shot. Why not? Shoot from everywhere. Scoreless game in this all-important gold medal matchup. Here's Maurer. Prohorkin, though. Prohorkin spins away from Erhoff. Good play by Prohorkin. Gavrikov sifts it in below the goal line for Barabanov. Barabanov trying to get away from Maurer. Barabanov goes to the backhand, and it's in behind the goal again. Good cycle game from the OAR, and Prohorkin goes back to the point. Gavrikov to Prohorkin. He dumps it in for Erhoff, and this is probably the best cycling shift we've seen from the OAR.
Yeah, it's good control, but look who's got the puck now. Germany's got it back. They've been able to make line changes. They are set up behind their own goal. They're deciding how they want to break up from here. If they leave this zone here again with ease, it shows you they're totally in command. They got out, but it wasn't perfect.
Here's Boyle. Just a shade over 3 minutes remaining in this period. Here's Wolf. Wolf snakes along the dasher board and charges below the goal line. Wolf trying to go back to Hordler in a jam play off a broken play as Reimer popped up out of nowhere. Here's Zubarev. Zubarev to Gusev. Gusev just feathers that out into the neutral zone, and that's picked up by Boyle. Boyle off the right skate of Reimer. Marcel Gotch, the captain, in, and he dances around Zubarev. Great play by Gotch, and Reimer tries to bunt that out of the air. It would have been a high stick either way, but Germany buzzing right now. Here's Kaprizov to Gusev. Gusev unloads on the one-timer. Good kick save with the right pad by Austin Birkin. Kink to Fausser. Fausser low and away. Kushechkin out to the top of the blue paint. You're not going to beat him from there. Here's Kalinin. Kalinin puts on the brakes. Kalinin against the grain, looking for a play in front, but Andronov waved at it and it bounced away. 2:09 remaining in period one. End-to-end action. Kovalchuk back to Nesterov.
OAR just increased by a half a gear their intensity offensively in the last minute and a half.
Here's Kisilevich. Kisilevich tucks in behind the goal line. Here's Gavrikov. Gavrikov, two goals and an assist so far at the Olympics. He goes up the right side to Telegin. Here's Kablikov. Kablikov trying to go around, shoots and shoots. Good body position by Schutz. Keeps everything to the outside, but now a giveaway. Telegin. Telegin shoots. It's blocked by Moritz Muller, and Muller is laboring after that shot. Good shot block, though. Telegin picks it up. Voinov. Gavrikov. Gavrikov with the shot, and it's blocked by Hager. Everyone collapsing in a gold jersey to try and help out Danny Austin Birkin. Two good shot blocks from Germany. 1:15 to go in a scoreless first period.
And another telltale sign. Germany in behind their own goal, and OAR decide, rather than to pursue the issue after they had had some sustained pressure, get a line change and make sure they were fresh to not be in a position vulnerably in the end of this opening 20.
1 minute remaining in the opening stanza. OAR out shooting Germany 10-6. Here's Sherikov. Sherikov skies it across the ice. Barabanov takes it down with the glove, and that'll be offside with 48.2 seconds remaining in this exciting first period.
This was not the billing of the gold medal game ahead of PyeongChang 2018. I think we all accept that. But what's happening right here are the two best teams in the tournament are playing a fantastic hockey game. And every single one of the players, particularly with Germany, are playing as they need to, or maybe a little bit better. As watch here, Gusev with a little feed inside and then backside for Datsyuk. Closed the door twice against OAR. Gusev able to slide it in, and then Datsyuk, that's as good a chance as you want to have, as Austin Birkin fronts up, as he has done on every shot so far. He's had 10 to face in this game from the OAR. He has been that good so far, Danny Austin Birkin. It's not just the zero on the board for OAR, it's the calm in which he's measured and making the saves.
Prohorkin tries to rip it across the blue line for Barabanov, but it will be Boyle taking over for Germany. And Boyle didn't get the red line there. He's had a good first period, Darryl Boyle, but he did not get the red line, so this is dangerous. Offensive zone faceoff on the icing. Germany will have to get this faceoff. You do not want to concede with 39.9 seconds remaining, especially when Boyle was a foot away from the red line.
They've done that twice now in this game, Germany. It's not good.
Face off to the right of Austin Birkin. Cahoon versus Datsyuk. Datsyuk wins it. Datsyuk back to the point. Gusev dumps it into the far left corner, but it's Jonas Muller. Muller gives it away to Gusev, and then a shot comes through from Gavrikov. He had Kaprizov in front, but somehow Austin Birkin saw it. Here's Boyle. 20 seconds remaining. Boyle is happy that that icing call didn't cost his team, but they're still hemmed in. Here's Datsyuk. Datsyuk to Gusev. Gusev trying to stay outside of Jonas Muller. Deflected in front. Kaprizov with the great hands in front on that play by Gusev. Kaprizov with four goals in the competition has been dangerous here in the first period. Voinov with the shot. Voinov scores. Just half a second remaining. Goodness. goodness gracious, hemmed into their own zone, and Germany gets scored on with less than a second remaining, and that is some kind of shot from Voinov.
You cannot allow Mother Russia to be reigning over you. Here comes OAR, and they knock your lights out just as quick as you give them a chance. That all starts from the icing call against for Germany. And here, with 0.5 seconds to go in the first period, OAR blasted high and hard.
Voinov with his second goal of the competition at 19:59 officially, but you see there 0.5 of a second remaining. And that icing call from Boyle, look, they recovered a little bit from the icing call, but then they threw the puck up the left side, and you do not want to give the puck to that man. Two-time Stanley Cup champion, Vyacheslav Voinov, and that's his second goal of the competition, and a rocket of a shot, nothing Austin Birkin can do. 20 minutes in the books from Gangneung Hockey Center, men's ice hockey gold medal game, OAR 1, Germany no score.
For Germany, whilst it's probably impossible emotionally, you've got to draw a line after 20 minutes and say to yourself, ahead of this game, would we have accepted being down by one shot at the end of 20 minutes? And you would have said, yes, we would accept that. The only challenge being is that Germany actually shot themselves in the foot at the end of 20 when they had been almost immaculate in their opening period here in a gold medal game. It doesn't mean it's over. What it simply means is you allowed OAR to move in from the middle lane, and they moved into the fast lane. And when they get in the fast lane, they'll blow your doors off.
0.5 seconds remaining when Voinov teed off and ripped that pass. Danny Austin-Birkin, shots on goal in the opening 20. OAR 12, Germany 6. Both teams 0-for-1 on the power play. They're playing for the gold medal. They're using the gold puck, the much sought after gold puck, and the much sought after opening goal goes to the Olympic athlete from Russia squad, Voinov, second from Gusev with his seventh assist, and Kirill Kaprizov with his second assist. But it is one of those old things you never want to concede in the last minute of a period, and Germany, as you said, have to put a line under that, but that is a killer with 0.5 of a second remaining.
Well, is it ever? And it's intimidating as all get out to be able to. You think you can just slide out the back door after the out of the first 20 minutes? No, no. We're going to make you pay, and they did.
OAR 1, Germany no score after 20 minutes of play at Gangneung Hockey Center. Well, tensions were high early, but both teams came out looking for a chance to open the scoring, and it was Seidenberg. Good net front presence by Wolf and Maurer. Austin Birkin, you said it off the top, had to be the best player on the ice at times. He was.
He certainly was, and you can't really fault him for what happened at the end. I think that's a breakdown that kind of lets him down, as there were some good shots in motion here. Then a breakaway. Kaprizov, who's got speed. When you've got speed, foot speed behind your shot equally, you've got every opportunity to be successful offensively, as you see the hit there coming in there from Nesterov. And both teams played physical, but it wasn't really an ingredient or a distinctive quality of the opening 20 minutes. It was more to do with the thoughtfulness and the smarts about how they played the game.
Kaprizov with the great hands. Gusev is so dangerous. I mean, Nesterov works him from the point, but watch Gusev here. Opens up the lane for Kaprizov. Double save from Austin Birkin on the two most dangerous characters, Kaprizov and Datsyuk.
Datsyuk is a fantastic hockey player. He's not a pure scorer like a Kovalchuk. He's not a one-time king, but in that position there, he could have very easily scored.
Look at the work by Kaprizov. Kaprizov to Gusev. Voinov with half a second remaining in the first period.
There's just something to be said about a goal taken at that moment in that situation when they created their own luck. It says you're lethal. And basically, it reminds OAR, we are that good when they go back into their dressing room for this intermission.
playing for gold. There is no tomorrow. Both teams leave it on the ice in the opening 20. And after that first period, the OAR lead Germany 1-0. Voinov second from Gusev and Kaprizov. Second period action coming up from Gangneung Hockey Center. What an opening 20 minutes of action at Gangneung Hockey Center. It was a late goal. Well, that's an understatement. Just 0.5 seconds remaining on the clock. It couldn't have come any later off the stick of Voinov. His second goal of PyeongChang, Gusev and Kaprizov, the assist. But with just 0.5 of a second remaining on the clock, it was a really tightly contested opening 20. But Voinov, the difference on a late goal. And you know what? Give the OAR credit. They stuck with it and they played right to the final buzzer. You look at the shots on goal, 12-6 in favor of the OAR. Both teams 0-1 on the power play. The killer for Germany was the icing call with about 39 seconds remaining from Boyle.
Yeah, it was. You know, the way Voinov took that goal at the end of the first period reminded me of what Kovalchuk did in the American game, where I had just mentioned that he'd been a little bit quiet and we hadn't seen a whole lot of him. And then about 12 seconds to go in the period, and then he took a feed on a one-timer just at the top of the circle and just knocked the lights out of the Americans. And then they came back inside the third period, and he bookended that second intermission break, and he took the feed down the wing and then just shot an absolute rocket up over the American goalkeeper's shoulder. They do that to you, does the OAR. They do stuff that other people can't do, and other teams really don't have the gear to be able to get to. They ring the bell with 0.5 seconds to go in the opening 20. Other teams would probably accept that time was going to just elapse and slip away and say, you know what, okay, we'll just let it go. Not OAR, they just, if they know that it's possibly on as far as a chance to get a shot in on goal and there might be just enough time to do so, they're gonna take it. And they just did it in such scintillating fashion there. It was masterful.
Koshechkin, 6 saves in the opening 20. He has been a giant, literally and figuratively, in the nets for the OAR in this competition. Koshechkin coming into this game with 2 shutouts and a 1.08 goals against average. Austin Birkin with 11 saves in the opening 24 Team Germany. Both teams 0-1 on the power play. Something that Marco Sturm and Team Germany are going to want to do better, the faceoff dot. OAR 57.9% in the faceoff. That kills you down the stretch in the defensive zone.
That's an area you can control if you're at the German side. You have to control what you can control. What you can't control is a guy who has electrifying ability like Voinov doing what he just did, other than not doing the icing at 39 seconds. But you have to control those set pieces, and Germany have to dictate terms there.
Hager versus Andronov, the restart for the second period. 1-0 OAR after 20 minutes in this gold medal showdown. PyeongChang 2018. Voinov with his second goal of the Olympics by way of just 0.5 of a second remaining in that first period. Gusev and Kaprizov, the assist. Shots on goal, 12-6 in favor of the OAR. Here comes Ilya Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk trying to sweep to the net. Kovalchuk knocked down. Good play by Masek, stayed with Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk trying to stick out the right arm and leg to make himself big there, but no room down the left side. Here's Kiselevich. Kiselevich with a shot and a good active stick by Christian Ehrhoff in the shooting lane, deflecting that up into the meshing.
Starting this second period, OAR have come out and picked up, as you might expect, on what is a very buoyant finish to the opening period. There you see Marco Sturm. They've got to respond here, Germany. They can't spend a lot of time, though, bending against OAR, or they'll break them again.
Gotch versus Datsyuk. Now, we talked about it a little bit there. 57.9% in the faceoff dot for the OAR in the opening 20. Something Marco Sturm would tidy up, and they've won 2 consecutive faceoffs here. So he's obviously said to the guys, the centermen in the locker room, let's start winning some of those faceoffs in our own zone. And a great job there by Germany. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg to Wolf. Wolf waved at that, but it's knocked down. Here's Kirill Kaprizov. Kaprizov with the dragon shoot, but Moritz Muller kept the stick right in that shooting lane again. Good defensive positioning, good sticks, and body positioning by the back end core of Germany.
Oh, it's been right on, and they have to continue to execute that way.
Here's Gusev looking for a lane. Gusev with a shot, he just lobs it up and over. He had Kaprizov in front, but the screen didn't matter as the shot was high and wide. Here's Zub, back pressure and gap management there from Big Wolf. He dishes it off to Cahoon, and Cahoon's shot was a weak one, low and away, but what a shift there by Wolf. Out front on the backhand, Maurer crashing in is Fausser. Maurer nearly found himself with an open net.
What a response from Germany after that opening minute of play in the second period.
Here's Sherikov. End-to-end action now as both teams get after it at the start, period two. Yashin Elitz tries to knock Sherikov down. Sherikov bounces right back up like a spring. Here's the goal scorer, Voinov, and Voinov looking for a deflection from Pohorkin, but it's gloved down by Ostenbirken.
Just like in the first period, all of these players, particularly Germany, are wanting to see how this is going to go in the second period. As they respond here well, and they've got to initiate. You can't stand around. You've got to forget what happened at the end of the first period here. I think OAR are wanting to see, are Germany going to stay with this, or are they staying still from what we just did to them? And it looks like Germany have responded, and they are capable of staying with this.
Maurer with that long stick was almost tied up in his own feet trying to get that shot off on Koshechkin. And Maurer, he did well to get a shot off, but again, when Koshechkin goes down, he takes up the whole bottom of the net. He's just too big to go low. You've got to try and go up. As we talked about, the lip of Fausser blocking a shot with his face against Switzerland in the playoff positioning game. That's a nasty injury, but a will to win when you're blocking pucks with your face.
Well, the face can heal. What can't is if you allow the opportunity here in a gold medal game or any of the games they've needed to win, Germany, to get to this position. You'll remember this the rest of your lives, and so will your children and your children's children. So go and do what it takes to win.
Here's Kink trying to take away the space of Kiselevich. Kiselevich holding up Kink. Kink has been one of the forces along the wall in this competition for Germany, but now Kink looks like he's hurt his wrist.
Well, he ran into his own man there. He hit him with the face there. He didn't see it, and then you're right. He may have just jammed his wrist. He went off in immediate hurry, but it's an unfortunate play, but he just ran into his own guy.
I was just about to say he's been a real force along the wall there, and when you play hard on the forecheck, on the cycle, sometimes you do jam up the wrists and whatnot, but he hit his own player there. Here's Hager. Hager back to Bjorn Krupp. Krupp to Erhoff. Erhoff with a shot across the blocker side of Koshechkin, but wide. Good net front presence from Plakta and shoots. Dumped in by Kablukov. Krupp goes up the right side. Hager tries to poke that away from Kovalchuk. Here's Kovalchuk. Just dumps in for Andrinov. Andrinov knocked down. I think Andrinov's trying to sell what would be a penalty opportunity, but the referees weren't buying that. Here's Andrinov. Andrinov tries to walk out front. That's a great A-frame by Seidenberg. Seidenberg's not a big man. He's like a fire hydrant, low and sturdy, and he kept Andrinov from moving a centimeter forward.
Anymore, it's actually more effective to be a little bit shorter because you're not coming over the top of your offensive players. You're playing underneath, and it's Plakta there. So he's got the puck, and Plakta, you know, I'm not sure what was going on there. He was looking to provide a screen, I think, or get out of the way, and he made, unfortunately, a little bit of a street post of himself, and Kink went into him at pretty good speed.
Looks like Kink is still on the bench getting looked over, but he would be a loss. He's integral to the offensive zone play, trying to bring those layers and the pressure against OAR. Kink running into Plakta. Being looked at on the bench, we'll keep an eye on that. Here's Wolf. Wolf and Gotch. Gotch trying to put that back into space for Reimer, but it's Gusev. Gusev is so quick with that first step. Gusev dumps it in. Kaprizov looking for a rebound. Of course, with a goaltender of the ability of Ostenbirken, and there will be no rebound on such a play, but not a bad idea by Gusev. You're going to at least get the offensive zone faceoff.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's just about being in the places you want to be. And there's Datsuk. He hasn't scored yet in this tournament. That's what I'm saying. I mean, he had that chance. He could score from that position that we saw on the highlights back in the first period. He doesn't need to be. What he does better than anybody, he makes players around them better than they actually are.
Slows the game down to his pace, the way he wants to play. They don't call him the magic man for nothing. Here's Moritz Muller. Another big faceoff. We talked about that Sturm would want more face-off wins. Well, tick that box if you're Germany. They've come out here and been pretty good in the dot. Wolf and Fauser. Fauser, look, he put a shoulder into Prohorkin. Prohorkin in behind the play is slow getting up after Fauser with a shoulder into Prohorkin. Here's Pock to Pock out front, and Fauser has become a thorn in the side of OAR. He knocked down Prohorkin and then goes to the front of the net. Here's Mosiakin. Mosiakin into the corner, Barabanov. Erhoff, first player there, goes to Nubles and now to Plakta. Plakta, dump and chase from Germany. They don't mind playing it simple here. They trail 1-0. Shots on goal, OAR 16, Germany 8. Voinov, the only goal in the game. It came with just half a second remaining in the first. Here's Erhoff. Erhoff and Telegen. Telegen trying to freeze it. Erhoff wants to move it. Telegen tries to squirt it forward for Grigorenko, but it will be Maurer. Maurer will dump it in for Germany.
Once again, they've done it within a foot, or with certainty within a stride, less than a stride, at the red line. They've played it down. As we look here for Harkin, he gets hit, and you can see by the whip of the head, he may have, in fact, suffered a little bit of whiplash right there. As you saw it, he was certainly woozy and disoriented there on that partial glancing blow.
It happened in behind the play, and Fauser might have got away with one there because that was certainly a blow to the head. Here's Gavrikov. Gavrikov with a silky delivery there and a good finish, but the flashing of the leather by Austin Birkin, again, impressive.
It is, because that was a very heavy shot coming in from the blue liner, and he put it low. It's easier to be able to make the save going up, but he made that glove hand save low, and he had to be ready because that thing was scooting.
That's a good point, because usually you see the goalies kind of streak up like that. He had to reposition, and Gavrikov with that hard shot low and away, well positioned. Another good stop by Ostenberg, and he's made 16 saves in the game so far. Masek to Seidenberg. Here comes Seidenberg. Shoots, had his stick broken, chopped out of his hands.
They've done it again.
They've got to get that red line.
Well, they're looking to make a play to Seidenberg, and he's gone to replace the stick on the bench, so he didn't know that he wasn't going to be ready to receive this puck. But it's just, you know, we just saw it at the end of the first period, what happens to you when you give a team like OAR additional opportunities. And you just don't want to see it for Germany. Reason being is that you just want to see everybody play to the best of their ability.
Can't keep giving away 200 feet of ice because you can't make 6 inches. You've got to gain that red line and make sure that you're not giving away the full ice pad to the OAR. They've already got a 1-0 lead. Here's Seidenberg, and they have that 1-0 lead because of that 39 seconds remaining icing call at the end of period one. Germany have done just about everything right if you want to look at simple North American hockey, play the game the right way with the layers, the forecheck. They've tied it up the faceoffs here in period number two, but they've got to stop icing the puck. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg to Hager. Hager had to come back and try and scoop that puck along with him. He put himself offside.
This second period so far has been a little bit disjointed, and that comes a little bit from when someone gives you a body blow, like they did, and there's a little bit of a rub on the way to the bench. There hasn't been too much sandpaper in this game as yet. As you look at Hager, he's a player very capable of bringing offensive thrust to this German side.
Here's Krupp, Bjorn Krupp, up the right side. Zub will take over for the OAR. Zub. Well, we're into the back and forth in the icing category here with the OAR leading 1-0. Voinov, his second from Gusev, and Kaprizov, the only goal so far.
Well, it's apparent that both of these teams are fans of tennis, as that's a little bit what's going on here.
A little back and forth. Gotch against Prohorkin. That's good news. Prohorkin's okay after he took that blow to the jaw, the chin. Looked like a bit of a whiplash play with Fauser trying to come across his body. But Prohorkin's out there, and another. That's four consecutive icing calls, two on each side of the puck.
I don't entirely understand why both of these teams are not executing with better precision right now. Gotch, with the good numbers, he's more of a defensive centerman, the leader, the captain of the side, as far as he's getting into his senior years of his career. But the little things, it's more of an issue for Germany because they're down by the one shot. But right now, both these sides are capable of playing better.
Maurer turns and fires. Pohorkin was trying to wheel with the puck there, and it squirted away from Pohorkin, and all of a sudden Maurer had a shot, but it was a bobbling puck, and it was gobbled up straight away by Koshechkin. OAR 1, Germany no score.
Austin Birkin with a chance to reset and recalibrate over there on the German bench. Both of these nations, likewise, you always see OAR, they are rather studious. They sit down and they're never really huddled around the front of their bench. They sit down, they use the opportunity for a little bit of respite when they're on that bench. They don't stand up and watch the play. They simply, when it's time and they're called, they go do their business on the ice. The rest of it is calm, generally, on their bench. The pageantry of the Olympic Games. It's a wonderful spectacle.
The greatest show on earth. Cahoon versus Kablikov. Cahoon trying to get it over to the left wing to Yashin Elits. That didn't quite work out, but they dump it back in. Voinov, who has the lone goal, dumps it up and down. It doesn't go for icing this time, and finally we have a break in that back-to-back icing calls on both sides of the puck. Here's Christian Ehrhoff. It was such a well-contested and intense first period. We thought there could be a feeling-out process. It's almost as if the feeling-out process has taken place here in the second period. Here's Telegin, and I mean that with full respect. Both of these teams know what's at stake. There was a lot of adrenaline in the opening 20, a lot of physical play, and here in the second period, it's come back down to earth and settled down a bit.
Well, to a degree, it's now got a chance to get real. It's a little bit like the first date. You're really excited and things are going along fine for the first 6 months, and then you get into normality. That's what's going on here.
Here's Nesterov. Kiselevich. Kiselevich back for Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk wheels to the outside. What a move by Kovalchuk! He had the puck on a string but couldn't get into a shooting position. Back to Kiselevich. Kiselevich with the shot high off the glass. It was actually Yashin Elits with a good stick out high for Germany, deflecting that Kiselevich shot. Well, Ilya Kovalchuk has brought another gear on this shift. Goes across to Zubarev. Zubarev wheels in behind Austin Birkin's net. Zubarev looking for the outlet pass. Goes back to the point. Here's Kalinin. Sergei Kalinin, a goal and two assists in the campaign so far for OAR. He went back to the point, nobody home, and Yegor Yakovlev will chase it down.
And one of the challenges to a second period in ice hockey is the long change. Because you're going the opposite direction, you have to, as a defenseman, work so much harder to get it forward, and maybe that's been a little bit of the reason for icings from both of the sets of D-men.
Backdoor play, Yakovlev. Datsyuk thought he had him at speed coming in from that left point, but Yakovlev broke too early. Yes, and that's why it's important to be the home team. You get the last change and the long change shorter, so that could be a factor. And here's a big hit by Seidenberg. Seidenberg roaring into Gavrikov. Gavrikov, to his credit, held his feet. Gusev goes high. It deflects off of Hordler up into the meshing. And now look at Seidenberg. He's only 5'7". Not afraid of anyone. He went after Gavrikov. He goes after Kaprizov.
In fairness to Seidenberg, he plays a strong front-up game, and he has played it and played the puck as you look there. And that little hitch of a head shake from Kovalchuk, that says something. And he's just winding and weaving his way through, doing what he does, but they've not been able to break this game open yet. And that, in the little tick as he looked at the scoreboard, is part of their frustration.
Pohorkin won the draw, but Kink pounces for Germany. 11:25 remaining in the middle frame. OAR 1, Germany no score. Voinov with just 0.5 of a second remaining in the first period. His second goal of PyeongChang, assisted by Gusev and Kaprizov. Here's Hordler. Germany trying to assert themselves in the offensive zone. Mosiakin went up the middle. Looked like Plokta was going to walk in on a bad play by that man, Sergei Mosiakin, but it just squirted out over the blue line.
Yeah, it's just an ill-timed play, and Mosiakin, another one of the lethal threats here from OAR. He plays most everywhere. He's on the power play. He'll work with Datsyuk. He'll work with Telegin. I mean, basically, they've got a number of different components that are interchangeable up and down this OAR lineup.
Mosiak, the captain of Metallurg Magnitogorsk. 48 goals 2 years ago for Metallurg. Unbelievable offensive player. Good captain is Mosiak. And at times, it's how deep the OAR. At times, he's been on the fourth line here.
Yeah, it just shows you, doesn't it, the options that you know, Snarak actually has. And that's why I say on paper, OAR are, and I'm not saying they're head and shoulders better than Germany, but they certainly are a stronger overall outfit.
The most skilled team on paper coming into the tournament and in the gold medal game where they believe they should be, and that's a high shot by Kablikov. Kablikov looked like he had Austin Birkin beaten but couldn't hit the net. Here's Hager to Masek. Masek, two goals in the competition, one of the more offensive-minded players. Here shoots, backhands it, and it's past Koshetskin. Shoots, stuck with it, and shoots, puts it on target. Looked like it went under the arm of Koshetskin. Germany have tied it up, and what a play by Felix Schütz.
This play looked like it had promise as it was developing, coming through the neutral zone. It's the advancement of the puck here from Masek. Masek goes around the defenseman and through him. Schütz on the backhand. I thought a penalty was coming against OAR as they impeded Schütz's ability to get the puck, and he throws it towards the net. Koshetskin is already committed the butterfly. It just finds a way as the big man almost does the work for Germany as he knocks it in with his own blocker. Luck is when preparation meets opportunity. In that instance there, simply, Germany took their chance. It's gonna go, and we'll just see.
We have a video review of a possible kicking action.
A possible kicking action. And I don't see that, but there have been some things that I thought I've seen that have gone other ways.
It should be Schütz's first of the competition from Masek and Hager. I was just about to say Hager, one of the more offensive-minded and gifted players for Germany. What a pass it was to Schütz. Well, you don't see the pass there, but he gets it to Schütz, and Schütz, well, that's a goal, and Hager never touched it.
Well, no, he didn't touch it. Are we going to suggest that Hager is in there in the blue paint and it's not going to be a goal? Because Koshetskin, he's no interference to Koshetskin. So if that's the issue here with Hager being in the crease.
I think the OAR are thinking did it
went
come off
his
the skate,
foot.
But
I
it
don't
never
believe
touched
so.
Him.
Not from never the other angle, it doesn't. So let's hope that's what is the evaluation here. Because if there is a discussion, he did clearly say they're looking for a foot action here.
Looking for a kicking motion. There was no kicking motion there. It never touches a player in the crease. It is shoots his goal if it's going to be a goal, and it went through the body of Koshetskin. It was a lovely feed by Masek to that man, Felix Schütz. And Schütz coming into this game, two assists, that would be his first goal. And what a time to get your first goal if you're Felix Schütz.
And you know what's even more impressive about that play is after he had been hooked kind of once and twice and OAR got away from it, it would have been easy just to take that puck below the goal line and behind the net and just keep it on your stick. And he took a chance, and he was rewarded.
Let's listen in to Alexei Rantala. He will make the final verdict.
After video review, there is no kicking action. It's a good goal.
Good goal, Germany. Should have been, and now it is.
As we said before, as soon as they say there is no kicking action, the way we see that in North America is they say it's no goal, and you get scared to what they're saying, but it just, there was no kicking action. That's what we were evaluating.
Schütz is first from Masek. Masek's second assist. Hager with a staggering fourth helper. 9 minutes and 32 seconds into the second period. And again, it's game on. We are even. It was 0-0 for 19 minutes and 59 seconds. There's a penalty coming up now to Germany. Voinov scoring with less than a second to go in the first. And now Schütz has tied it up, but it's going to be a power play for the OAR. Good job by Koshetskin to get to the bench and create the 6-on-5, but it's going to be Reimer for hooking.
Let's find out here just how mentally tough both of these nations are. Because for OAR, it is a chance now to return to the lead on this power play, right back after what they might have thought was a little bit of a weak goal. And for Germany, it's a chance now to hold tough, because you've leveled this game, you found a way, hold in there.
Second power play of the game for the OAR. They are 0-for-1. Here is Grigorenko. Reimer for hooking. Worked along the wall. Kalinin keeps his feet moving to Barabanov. Barabanov trying to get out for Grigorenko. This is an interesting start to the power play for the OAR. They bring out their third line, essentially, the crash and bash line, and Kalinin is camped in front. Kovalchuk on the point, and now Moritz Muller goes through Kalinin.
Wow. You saw Muller communicates with the referee, and he says, you know that was, he was selling to you there. And he says, yeah, I understand. And so here's the shot. It's just heavy right through the middle. Kalinin in a good position there, and then he steps over. I hope these guys don't get into the play-acting game that we saw in the bronze medal game, and we've seen it different times in this tournament.
Big face-off to the right of Austin Birkin. Kovalchuk versus Fausser. Kovalchuk will drift back. He's a forward, of course, but he plays the point on this power play. Here's Kovalchuk. Just outside the face-off circle. Back in play, and he looked to the point and faked it to the net. Trying to get Austin Birkin to come off the post. Crafty little play by Kovalchuk.
Is it ever? It's that kind of play that separates them. It's the kind of play that you got to remember, Kovalchuk has been regarded at peak times in his career as one of the best players in the world. So you do stuff when you're one of the best players in the world because you can.
Here comes Mosiakin. Mosiakin leaves it for Gusev. Gusev over the line. Rims it around for Mosiakin. Mosiakin with a nice play to Kaprizov, but Kink with the gap management. Kink saw that play and read and react perfectly for Germany.
Very disruptive and effective penalty kill so far from Germany. They are showing resolve.
They're feeling good after the shoots goal. They need to kill off this important situation. 5-on-4 for the OAR. Here is Datsyuk. Datsyuk stick handling in a phone booth over there. It's incredible what he can do in a small bit of space. Gets it ahead for Kaprizov. Kaprizov to Gusev. Gusev, such a good passer, all the way back to Mosiakin. Mosiakin with the slap pass. He was going back door, back post for Gusev.
Germany are a little bit fortunate there. They didn't clear it the last time, and they ended up having 15, 20 extra seconds and a pretty threatening look from OAR. They've got to clear it on their first attempt.
5 seconds remaining in the penalty to Reimer. Kovalchuk trying to make something happen here in the late power play stage. Kovalchuk back out, Kaprizov with the shot. It was off the shin pads of Seidenberg, and Reimer races out of the penalty box. It's a good penalty kill for Germany, but a dangerous moment at the end.
Kovalchuk just touched the electrifying button, and he almost did it there to take OAR in the lead. We are level at one in the gold medal game. That play, that sequence just ahead of this little pause, you saw what Kovalchuk can do. And what's so impressive is because he's so dynamic, you start to watch him thinking he's going to do it all by himself, and then he provides a service as he offloads it. As Austin Birkin, as we watch here, he takes that one just off the pumpkin and makes sure you're going to do whatever it takes to block it. This is the play here. The way Masek took this puck and the way they came to the neutral zone, shoots, comes up and takes what is available to him and shoots a forward, but a smart timed play. And equally, they just had puck support. They created their own luck there, did Germany. What a response.
Face off to the left of Austin Birkin. Gotch trying to tie up the stick of Prohorkin. Prohorkin got it back to Gavrikov. Gavrikov in deep for Barabanov. Here's Prohorkin. Prohorkin takes a bump from Hordler. Barabanov trying to squib it back to Gavrikov, but it's Wolf. Wolf and Reimer go forward. Reimer had that pass well behind him as Wolf just didn't have the room to go tape to tape with Reimer. Here's Hordler. Hordler slides it into the far corner, and here comes Wolf and Gavrikov. Gavrikov tries to finish his hit off, but Wolf got the stick on that and got it to Reimer. Reimer backdoor for Seidenberg. Seidenberg with the shot, and Koshechkin gets across to make the stop.
I can guarantee you right now on OAR's bench, their blood pressure is rising, and they have the responsibility and the pressure as a long reigning Olympic previous champion. Germany has never won Olympic gold, and right now, as you're seeing them at least threatening goal, they are starting to flirt with even discussing the idea.
Zub ahead for Telegin. Telegin Good stick by Boyle. Boyle just swept that into the corner, but Telegin stays with it. Here's Zubarev. Zubarev with the shot. It got through. Grigorenko with the good screen in front for OAR. Here's Kavlukov. Kavlukov pushed off the puck momentarily by Erhoff. Good battle with Kavlukov and Erhoff. Not for the faint of heart. Elbows and cross checks and all sorts. And looks like Erhoff and Kavlukov. There's a call in behind the play. It's Boyle. Boyle took a stick to the kisser there.
I think this is a penalty coming up against the OAR, but OAR had possession of the puck at the time, didn't they? And because we're so busy watching the play, that looked to have gone off the play. And so it is. It's going to be a penalty against OAR, as it is Boyle. That's the play. Erhoff was just starting to cross-check a little bit here, and he got a stick up. And, oh, it's the,
right
it's
there,
the elbow.
Yeah.
There it is.
Well, look, the stick came up into Boyle's face there.
And it was, I thought it was the elbow, too, in a second here. As he comes, he catches him. And I thought the elbow, we saw it sharp, but it's the stick. And that'll do it.
Kavlukov for high sticking. It's 2+2. It's a four-minute high sticking penalty. You can see that Boyle is cut.
Oh, he's got good. He's been cut well.
It's one of those situations. It was a good battle between Kavlukov and Erhoff. We're watching that, and as Kavlukov tried to get the puck away, the stick, the point of his blade got into the cheekbone.
Oh, there's no question that it's a four, but let's just watch it again.
Here's Erhoff and Kavlukov. Watch Boyle coming in over the shoulder.
I thought it was
the elbow. It's not the elbow, it's stick right there.
Oh, yeah.
And it's the stick of Erhoff.
It is, isn't it? It's the stick
of Erhoff. It's Erhoff's stick, not Kavlukov.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, this is tough. I don't know if they can't do anything about this now. They've made this call.
Well, now it appears they're reversing the call. They're reversing the call. At the 13-minute mark of the second period, reversing the call. Kavlukov has come out of the penalty box and from a 2+2 to nothing.
I didn't think you could review such a thing, but the right call is being made by rescinding the call, but that's incredible.
You can clearly see it was Erhoff's stick, but the call was 2+2 for high sticking because of the bloodied cheekbone of Boyle. And the call is reversed. So from a chance for a lengthy power play, Germany have to shake that off as the referees, Alexei Rantala and Mark Lemelin, with what is a questionable moment there if you're Germany. You would have loved that power play, but you could see it was Erhoff's stick.
Well, they didn't deserve the power play, although to the naked eye, it looked like they did. That's what the scope of review and four sets of eyes will do now.
Here's Ilitz, Yashin Ilitz. Yashin Ilitz across the body, Maurer was there. Well, would they shake it off and forget about the lost power play? Well, they did. Yashin Ilitz with a good job there for Germany. Here's Muller, Moritz Muller. Gains the red line. Dumps it in on Koshechkin. Koshechkin just gloves it down for Kisilevich. 1-1 OAR and Germany. 6 minutes to go in the second stanza. Shots on goal, OAR 19, Germany 12. Here's Kink. Kink trying to get outside of Zubarev. Kink works his way to the goal line, and Koshechkin had to go down and make sure to hug that post.
Let's put this whole situation into perspective here now, as it is a 1-1 score getting deep in the second period in a gold medal game, OAR and Germany. The Soviet Union from 1956 through 1988 won 7 gold medals at the Olympic Games from 9 tournaments. As we look at some of the action here from Germany, who have never won a gold medal. They've won 2 bronzes, and they were 44 years apart, 1932 and 1976. They've never won a gold, and right now they are taking on one of the powerhouses of the sport of ice hockey, and they are creating questions and uncertainty. I'd never got the impression from OAR in this tournament that they felt entitled to come away from PyeongChang with a gold medal, but it's certainly what everybody else has been suggesting. And right now, I think that talk is quieting down.
Well, with each passing minute, you are correct. Germany are in this game as they were against Sweden, as they were against Canada. Fouser wins the draw, blocked it with a hard shot. Koshechkin came roaring out of the net to get a blocker on that. With each passing minute, this will put the doubt between the ears of the OAR and the confidence growing for Team Germany. They've already knocked off Sweden, the silver medalists from Sochi, with an overtime win in the quarterfinals. They knocked off the defending gold medal champions, Canada, in the semifinals. Can they get the job done here? They have played a magnificent game plan. They dropped their first two games of the tournament and have won four straight to be in this position. Marco Sturm has done a magnificent job behind the German bench. And the German roster has all been on the same hymn sheet. But now a two-on-one. Here's Gavrikov. Gavrikov to Voinov. Voinov deflected it wide. It was an excellent block by Seidenberg on the first pass across from Gavrikov.
That could have easily been a goal. We all know it. We all saw it. And it just was short of execution.
And in these tight games, Germany have been good. They've won a shootout game and two overtime games in PyeongChang. So they'll be happy if this looks like it could be a looming overtime. OAR will not want to go to overtime against Germany. Germany have had a lot of belief. They've had a lot of guys step up and be heroes. Seidenberg and Reimer, of course. Here's Hager. Hager into the corner. Takes a bump from Zub, but Hager A-frames in the dasherboard and keeps the puck alive for Germany. Here's Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff with the shot, and Hager was camped out in front. Somehow, Koshetskin got the left pad on that. Here's Hager. Pressure now. Dangerous moments for the OAR. Germany feeling good. Boyle with the shot, and Hager deflected it in front. Here's Masek. Masek and Hager, two of the more offensively gifted players for Germany, trying to get a lead here. They haven't led this game. Of course, the OAR had a 1-0 lead on a goal by Voinov with less than a second to go in the first. Germany, 9 minutes and 32 seconds into this period, shoots with his first of the competition, giving us that 1-1 scoreline. Boyle flips it out into the neutral zone. Kiselevich off the skate of Kablukov. Telegin. Telegin works his way down the right side. Telegin, such a powerful skater. Telegin. Back to Nesterov. Nesterov to Grigorenko. Grigorenko turns and fires. Telegin goes and finds the rebound. Pretty good stop there by Austin Birkin as he patted it away into a dangerous, an undangerous area, if you will. His rebound control has been good.
OAR is so clean that they can make a pass from the goal line out to the high blue line, take it on the backhand, move it to another guy, and then get a good shot on goal.
Reimer trying to go through the body of Kiselevich. Kiselevich blocked that and springs Andronov. Andronov, 3-on-2 developing for OAR. Andronov cross ice, but Kovalchuk had to take it on the backhand, couldn't get into a shooting position. Here's Andronov dancing away from Krupp. Kovalchuk pulled down by Wolf. Kovalchuk looks back at the referee. The officials say play on. Here's Kalinin. Kalinin battling with Moritz Muller. Moritz Muller does a good job, just activates the puck ahead for Wolf. Wolf being watched by Datsyuk. Wolf desperate to get it out. He gets his pocket picked by Gusev. And now Datsyuk. Datsyuk on the backhand, and Austin Birkin comes up big there.
David Wolf almost just got taught a lesson. He spent a little too much time hanging around the fire, and he almost got burned. As you watch the play here, this is Seidenberg, who steps and lays down, makes himself as big as possible. What he did is he just changed the timing of the pass across in front of the net. That one's always a good idea. Just couldn't get out of the way there, Hauger. And then here now, Datsyuk with a backhand, and Austin Birkin has to bail out his teammate.
That backhand had some steam on it. You hear people talk about the backhand being a dying art. Well, a guy like Pavel Datsyuk can shoot just as hard on the backhand as he can on the forehand. So that's a good stop by Austin Birkin. Zubarev has to be careful. Fauser, great gap management there. Looked like he had no space to make a play, and Fauser was all over Zubarev.
Well, they have to provide that, don't they? They have to provide that puck pressure, and they have to be assertive, and they've got to be smart when they do get it. And they've done all those things, Germany. They've not been perfect, Germany, but they have been good enough to be level with 2:11 to go in the second period at one.
Voinov for the OAR, Felix shoots for Germany. 1-1, 2:11 to go in the second period. Gold medal battle between these two hungry teams trying to end a 26-year gold drought is the OAR. Germany have never won Olympic gold, so some sort of streak or drought will be broken here. And we thought if it was close after period one, it would be an exciting game because of the way Germany have hung around against big teams like Sweden and Canada, and they have provided exactly the kind of game plan that Marco Sturm has asked to be executed. Here's Muller. Seidenberg. Seidenberg up the right side. Again, that'll be an icing call against Germany with 1:59 remaining in the second period.
Some of the tactical strategy from the defense is to advance the puck into a positive area, hoping that your forwards can get on the end of it. And unfortunately, for both teams, more for Germany in this second period, they've had that without or beyond their reach, and it's gone for icing. They've got another defensive zone faceoff here now inside of 2 minutes.
Cahoon wins the draw against Prohorkin. Seidenberg advances the puck for Dominic Cahoon. Cahoon to Plock, to back to Cahoon. Cahoon inside out move. Cahoon with the shot. Cahoon trying to go five hole, and Kuszczykin shut the door. Good stop by the OAR netminder.
That situation for Germany was a good enough opportunity in which to score and take the lead in this game.
Dominic Cahoon, that first step off the blue line was as quick as a cat, slicing through the defense of the OAR. And now here comes Schutz. Schutz already has one barreling down that right wing. Has to hold up, though, as he was being watched by Gavrikov. Masek and Hager. Hager trying to walk out front. Hager against the grain. Backhand pass for Masek. It was off his skate. Here comes Sergei Mozyakin. Erhoff intercepts that, but it's into the body of Sherikov. Erhoff stays with it and gets the puck to Masek. Masek and shoots to Hager. Schutz got the red line that time and dumped it in. No icing. 1 minute remaining in the second period. Here comes Kablikov. Kablikov with a shot. It was low and away. He's looking for a tip from Telegin.
I thought that play just ricocheted and almost accelerated towards goal. But this is what OAR can do. They can raise the heat in the last minutes.
Here's Zubarev. They had a goal with just half a second remaining in period one. They look for a late salvo here in period two. Here's Telegin. Telegin's shot. Kablikov trying to get there. 30 seconds remaining in the second period. A 1-1 scoreline in this magnificent gold medal showdown. Here's Kablikov. Kablikov tries to go back to the point. Zubarev will retreat. Here's Wolf. Wolf to Muller. They try for their own last-minute magic here, Germany. Reimer. Erhoff. Erhoff tried to kick it forward. Kalinin pounces. 5 seconds remaining in the second. Gotch. Smart defensive player for Germany. Didn't try and advance the puck. Just put it into a safe area. And Erhoff will wind the puck down. Wind the clock down. 40 minutes of play are done and dusted at Gangneung Hockey Center. Gold medal action. Germany and the Olympic athlete from Russia squad all tied up 1-1 with 1 period to go in this Gangneung Hockey Center final day of competition, and it has not let us down one iota.
It has not indeed. It's been as advertised, or what you want to see in a gold medal game. What you want to see is you want to see the two best nations competing against each other and both giving each other as good as they can receive and equally as good as they can provide. And that's what's happening here right now. And forget the form book as far as what we read on paper and what was the rankings and who was favored. All of that doesn't matter anymore. It's just 20 more minutes of play as we're moving into the latter stages of this gold game.
The word around the Team Germany backroom staff, the roster, was they wanted to have a close first period and throw everything. They wanted to give them a chance in this gold medal showdown. Well, they trailed 1-0 after 20 minutes of play. They get the only goal in period two, and it's game on for the third period at Gangneung Hockey Center. Goals from Voinov for the OAR, his second of the competition, assisted by Gusev and Kaprizov. And in the second period, 9 minutes and 32 seconds into the second period, Felix shoots his first from Masek and Hager. 0-2 on the power play for the OAR, 0-1 for Germany. Shots on goal, 21-14 in favor of OAR, but Germany know that they can create history and win that gold medal for the first time ever. OAR and Germany tied 1-1 after 40 minutes of play.
There you see both teams like they were turning to battle in the second period. The battle in the trenches in front of their respective goalkeepers. looking to respond. And this the a play there from Kazetskin. He actually loses his stick. He's down there and gets wound. And then this is a little bit of an awkward play. It was Plakta just bumping into Kink, and it looks like it was a shoulder that was mostly the issue. We haven't seen a lot, I think, of Kink since then. I don't think at all. But this Prohorkin, he gets hit too. And you just see the way he lets up. His body kind of goes limp there. It looked like for a second he not only had been dazed, but that he was in a situation. And then it says now Kovalchuk just picking up his athletic ability and speed and game break ability as he just rotates around, just looking for any loose puck or certainly creating it. That's a shot off the mask. That's really anymore, no longer really a big deal in ice hockey, but I guess if it catches you flush, it can be. And this, the shoots goal. They really did create their own good fortune here, Germany. And they didn't create something from nothing, but they certainly created something from what was kind of a half chance. And they got the favorable bounce off of the big Russian keeper as it went off of his own arm, and he ended up giving it momentum to go across the line. And then Seidenberg, as he has done all tournament, looking to be as disruptive as he can for a rather diminutive defenseman, and getting in the way and adjusting the timing of OAR on the offensive attack.
One-one OAR Germany after 40 minutes of play in the men's ice hockey gold medal game, Gangneung Hockey Center. It has been top class, top to bottom in this men's ice hockey tournament, and it's come down to the wire. 20 minutes to play, nothing separating these two teams. Voinov scored in the first period for the OAR. The only goal in the second was Felix Schutz, his first of the competition, from Masek and Hager. Hager with his fourth assist. He's been absolutely on top form for Germany.
They certainly have been. They've been able to link together what has become potentially a gold medal winning performance at the Olympic Games, the first time ever. It's an incredible situation what's going on here as we look at the shots on goal. 9-2-8 in the advantage of OAR. It might be that the Voinov goal at the end of the first period is the most flamboyant goal that this game is going to see, because the next goal, in the way the game is playing out, feels very much like it's going to be either an inadvertent, accidental, it could be a goal that was maybe not intended, or it may not have been shot to the place that they were hopefully trying to locate it, and it's going to go in. And it could be a goal that holds. It could be a goal that separates the two sides and determines the color of the medal that each of these respective teams are going to take away from PyeongChang 2018.
21-14, the shots on goal overall in favor of the OAR. Something that Germany needed to work on after the first period. The OAR in period one, 57.9% in the faceoff dot. Germany do better in period two because the domination of the OAR comes down. 51.1% for the OAR now. So Germany started winning some faceoffs. They got their feet moving, and you saw that on the Schutz goal. Just a well-worked play by Masek and barreling forward by Schutz. Nothing fancy.
Interestingly, as you look at the fans in the stands, the Germans very much enjoying this situation as it is right now. And the Russian fans, well, they're enjoying it too. This is the grand stage of all stages in ice hockey, but they feel like they've got something to lose, and Germany feels like they might have something in which to win today.
Dominic Cahoon, two shots on goal for Germany. Christian Ehrhoff, 15 minutes and 32 seconds time on ice for Germany. For the OAR, Kirill Kaprizov, three shots on goal, and Bogdan Kiselevich, 14 minutes and 3 seconds time on ice. Koshechkin made some big saves in that second period. Couldn't get the arm down to the body on the Schutz chance, but he does have 13 saves so far in the OAR net.
Part of the challenge of being so big sometimes is there's a lot of moving parts in goal. Austin Birkin has been as good as he's needed to be to keep his side in it.
20 saves for Austin Birkin. 1-1 after 40 minutes of play. Buckle up, third period action underway at Gangneung Hockey Center. The OAR looking to end a 26-year drought in the gold medal department. Germany looking to win their first ever Olympic men's ice hockey gold. Nothing separating these two teams through 40 minutes. 1-1. Here comes Andronov. Andronov pushed off the puck by Hager. Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff. Not looking like a player that's played almost 16 minutes already. Ehrhoff has plenty of spring in his step for Germany. Here's Schutz. Schutz lofts it high into the air at Gangneung Hockey Center. Taken down by Kiselevich. Kiselevich will throw it up the neutral zone there. It was hit on the way through the neutral zone, so no icing. Here's Reimer. Gotch. Gotch down the right side. Gotch just rolls it up, looking for the rebound was Wolf, and Kuchetkin had to be careful there. Wolf had purpose in front of the OAR net.
Both of these keepers have to be careful now, as you see Kuchetkin just handing the puck off as the play comes up, advancing and simple. And also just putting the pucks into places in which they can be dangerous and make the keepers have to make saves under pressure.
Gotch versus Datsyuk. Datsyuk swoops it back for Zub. Zub goes up the right wing for Kaprizov. Kaprizov with the nice touch pass. He was looking for Gusev. Gotch had the stick lifted, bounced away from him, and here's Reimer. Reimer to Seidenberg. Yannick Seidenberg, the overtime hero against Switzerland. Muller looking for Dominic Cahoon. Cahoon puts on the brakes. Cahoon with the shot. It was blocked by Zubarev. Here's Kirill Kaprizov. Goes to the point, but no further. That's kept in and tipped. Tipped in front by Cahoon on the shot by Hordler. Here's Hordler again. Happy to just get pucks through now, Germany. Here's Cahoon. Cahoon with the shot. It was blocked by Zubarev.
Very promising opening sequence of play offensively for Germany.
And they're right back in. Trying to get that shot away quickly was Maurer. Maurer, though, dispossessed, but he'll back all the way up as Sherikov was trying to get forward for the OAR. Here's Prohorkin. Prohorkin poked away. Good stick by Maurer, but Zubarev was backing up Prohorkin. Ehrhoff will turn and chase it back. It's not necessary. It'll be an icing call against the OAR.
That's, well, we're just over 2 minutes of play, and Germany have come out here under the direction of that man right there. And I think as much as he's giving them a plan, I think he's giving them belief. And that's the biggest difference to this German side than ones we have seen previously.
Back to the point, and a quick shot by Plocht. A big faceoff win by Fausser. They've tied it up in the faceoff dot, and that leads to some offense there as Plocht got a good shot on goal.
He is very effective as Plocht. He's able to get to loose pucks, get into situations. He's able to hang on the puck, and he gets a shot off quickly there through a screen and makes sure that it has to be a save by OAR.
Fausser versus Kablikov. They'll do it all again to the right of big Vasily Kuchetkin. Former Tampa Bay Lightning pick is Kuchetkin. We talked about his size, 6'7". He's intimidating in the net, but Boyle trying to take away that intimidation factor. Just wide, Ehrhoff with the big shot. Fausser in front, screening. Kuchetkin. Kuchetkin had that bounce off his right pad as Plocht is willing to shoot from anywhere.
Germany are the better team to start this third period by some significant margin.
Here's Telegin. Telegin. Telegin with the shot, and it's stopped by Austin Birkin. And he had to be careful. Kablikov was camped out in front. Big stops at both ends of the rink. Here's Yakovlev. Yakovlev is filled in by Kink. Run and gun stuff. Here's Telegin. Telegin to Kablikov. Blocked shot by Krupp. What a play by Bjorn Krupp. Here's Schutz. He has the lone goal for Germany. Goes back to Plocht. Plocht to Bjorn Krupp. Hager and Krupp play catch. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg trying to sift it up to Masek. Masek had to come back for the puck, and that's unfortunate. If that came to any sort of speed to Masek, he might have been away.
The response from OAR, they show a flicker of flamboyance as they come through the neutral zone. They know that they've been hemmed in their own zone, and they come straight out. It's just one shot that potentially is going to be required to push yourselves forward in this now, remaining under 17 minutes of play.
Hager wins the faceoff back for Bjorn Krupp. Bjorn Krupp in his first Olympic Games, tucked in behind Austin Birkin. Krupp trying to spring Masek. Masek got a piece of that. No, he didn't get a piece of it. It will come all the way back. The right idea by Krupp, but the wrong execution up the right side.
He tried to elevate the puck to get it past the first forechecker's stick that is put into a position in which to make life challenging for you. You see the discussion going on there. And Ciroc, I mean, this is a handful right now for the OAR coach and his staff. And this entire situation is just a little bit like the plot is thickening and it's getting heavier.
Masek has the puck in his feet. Stick lifted by Kovalchuk. Znarek has won wherever he's gone. He's three times he's won the Gagarin Cup in the KHL, including last year with SKA. He led this side to a world championship gold medal in 2014. He wants that Olympic gold medal, but right now Germany giving all that they can handle.
Remember the story about Russia as a competing nation, as it's been a long time since they've won a gold medal as well. For Germany, their record, those two defeats to Finland and Sweden, and that's where Marco Sturm says, we got better there. We learned why we lost, and we went out and we implemented it in our successive games after that.
Gotch versus Datsyuk. Datsyuk with another face-off win. Datsyuk looking to become a member of the Triple Gold Club. He has the Stanley Cup rings. He has the World Championship gold. He only lacks the Olympic gold medal to become the 28th member of the Triple Gold Club. Here's Kaprizov, pushed into the corner by Muller. Here is the aforementioned Datsyuk, and he runs into the shoulder of Marcel Gotch, the two captains coming together. Two ex-NHLers battling. Bad giveaway by Wolf. Wolf just gives it softly up the Gusev, and it's tipped in front by Kaprizov. Kordler to Wolf. Wolf is usually so strong up the wing. He just gave the puck away to Gusev, but Germany get away with that one. Here's Reimer. Reimer was the hero against Sweden in overtime. Kiselevich. Kiselevich trying to kick the puck along the wall. He goes off the glass to Nesterov. Nesterov for Kaprizov. Here's Christian Ehrhoff. Line change coming for OAR, but Christian Ehrhoff has to go back. Well, Hordler was looking for Maurer, and Maurer had no idea what Hordler was doing, so that's going to come back on an icing play.
An elevated clearing play, the idea to make the pass here. David Wolf, he's done that a couple of times. He's tried to be cute. He's a big bull of a man, and he equally has some very delicate, almost surgeon's touch hands, but he falls in love sometimes when that puck's on his stick and he makes soft decisions. You can't against OAR.
Cahoon with the face-off win. Here's Christian Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff never seems to leave the ice for Germany. Here's Cahoon, Dominic Cahoon down the right side. Kablikov takes over, but Yashin Elitz was right in his face causing all sorts of problems. Good play by Elitz. Cross ice for Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff puts a shot in on goal looking for the rebound for Maurer, but it was well handled by Kushechkin. Here's Boyle. Boyle dumps it in high off the glass. Yegor Yakovlev up the right side for Telegin. Both teams know a mistake here, and it's critical. Situation critical. 1-1, 14 and a half minutes to go in the gold medal game. Here's Gavrikov for Telegin. Boyle. Seidenberg will gain the red line and dump it in. Change is coming. Fresh legs over the boards for Germany. Gavrikov cut off at the pass by Nubels. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg takes a hit from Andronov, but he was only happy to do so to try and move it the other way. Jonas Muller trying to pitchfork it along the wall. Good play by Kaprizov. Kaprizov with the quick hands trying to spring Andronov. Andronov. Good play along the wall. Good board play and cycle from the OAR. But here's Plakta. Plakta gains the red line, gains the blue line. And again, Germany happy to dump it in and get a face-off in the offensive zone. 13:49 remaining in the third period. OAR and Germany tied 1-1.
There is a wide spectrum of consideration in this hockey game right now. For Germany, in fairness, they're keeping quite focused and keeping to the task. Very task-oriented. They're not getting overly reflective. They're not getting ahead of themselves. They're not worrying about the past. They're keeping in the moment. But if you look at OAR right now and look at the expression on some of their fans' faces and even in the players' eyes, they are wondering how scary could this be if we don't win this? And they're starting to think about that a little bit. And once that creeps into your mind, you start to create an extra opponent, yourself. The opening result, Slovakia get a hold of OAR before they got flying, and then four successive victories.
Big face-off to the right of Kiselevich. Masek couldn't turn on that puck. Here's Sherikov picking it up for the OAR. Nesterov calling for it, and Nesterov will take it. Kalinin for Barabanov. Barabanov battling with Hordler. Barabanov goes deep to Sherikov. Sherikov to the point. Nesterov walks across. Kiselevich plays catch with Nesterov. Nesterov puts the shot through, and he actually hit Barabanov in front. Barabanov trying to do his best to screen Austin Birkin, but he stops the puck getting through. Here's Kiselevich. Kiselevich pushed into the end. Dasher by Masek. Masek takes Kiselevich down. It's more of an MMA move than a hockey move, and the referee says play on. Here's Barabanov. Cut off by Erhoff. Hordler. Hordler ahead, looking for Wolf. Wolf. Wolf barreling ahead on Zub. Wolf is offside. He'll have to touch up, as does Reimer. Here's Zubarev. Zubarev hammers it in on Austin Birkin. Austin Birkin just pads it into the corner for Boyle. Boyle to Wolf. Wolf gave it away, and now you do not want to give it away to the Datsyuk line. Zubarev with the shot. Wolf looked up and saw Datsyuk and almost looked like he was frightened and surprised that Datsyuk was right there.
Datsyuk can kind of just come up on you. He can surprise you. He's in stealth mode generally most of the time, as he will just work his way around the ice, and he does it at times in quiet zones. Other times he can also be electrifying. As you look at the bench there, you're going to be getting tired. You're going to be equally wondering what if. The thoughts do exist in Germany's mind as well, but they have it all to win. It's such a possibility. It's just a challenge for OAR right now that they have this burden of expectation.
Seidenberg dumps it in. Gavrikov gets there for the OAR. Here's Bjorn Krupp. Bjorn Krupp, his dad, Juve Krupp, had a Stanley Cup winning goal for the Colorado Avalanche. Bjorn Krupp, 6'3". His dad was 6'6". Juve Krupp, a real legend of German ice hockey, has coached Germany. He's coached in the KHL. Bjorn Krupp has had a good tournament for Germany. Here's Kablikov. Kablikov trying to get by Seidenberg. Seidenberg holds up Kablikov, and Austin Birkin will hold on.
Well, just to reference back to Uwe Krupp, he had some of the best hair in the business. He was a big man. He could shoot the puck like an absolute beast. And you're right. He was a real flag wearer of the sport of hockey in Germany and what he was able to do in the National Hockey League.
He was a handful in front of the net, and so is Bjorn Krupp. Clears the crease well in front of Austin Birkin, but a good block there by Kink. It was a lovely shot by Kovalchuk, and Kink bravely goes down, because we all know Ilya Kovalchuk shoots the puck 100 miles an hour. Here's Kink showing no ill effects of that shot block. Kink up the left side, and that is brave stuff from Kink.
Well, you have to just make the smart, simple plays. The German side right now are doing what they're supposed to do in every situation.
Here's Jonas Müller. Müller, not known as an offensive defenseman, but he's rushing forward for Germany. Müller back to Hordler. Hordler waits up. Hordler trying to use Fausser as a screen in front, but Kiselevich pushed him out of the danger area. Hordler comes in, deflects out for Kaprizov. Kaprizov happy to take over for the OAR, as Germany need to make a line change. We're approaching the 9-minute mark of the third period. Here's Sherikov. Sherikov for Kalinin. Kalinin had that poked away by Schutz, and that'll be offside at the German line.
An interesting dynamic that we potentially anticipated is if OAR got into a situation where the game got tight late, they might have some internal squabbling going on that bench. We've not seen that. They have kept calm. They've kept unified as we look at the blocking effort here, which is part of what we thought might have been the frustration for OAR, the way Germany have been able to show that defensive resolve.
Zub hammers it in for the OAR. Darryl Boyle, first player on the scene. Boyle goes up the right side, gloved down by Yakovlev, and Yakovlev will dump that over the glass. It's deflected up and out of play with 10:53 remaining. OAR and Germany knotted at one in the men's ice hockey gold medal game, PyeongChang 2018. Voinov for the OAR, shoots for Germany. It has been tight, it has been tense, and the goaltenders have been absolutely superstar mode in both ends of the rink.
Pretty sure you wouldn't want to bet the house on either of these teams right now, because we have no idea the way this will go.
Gavrikov to Voinov. Voinov, who has that goal for the OAR, knocked down unceremoniously by Erhoff. And Masek was offside, and Hager with a smart little play to pirouette back and make sure there was no offside. They'll attack from the left side. They dump it in. Gavrikov slides it forward. Hager intercepted that. Sherikov trying to settle it down for the OAR as Seidenberg. Interesting there, a 2-3 from Germany. Two men forward, three men across the center ice line. Is some tactical changes from Marco Sturm as he tries to make that exit very difficult for the OAR.
He's very capable of exiting that, and equally his team are very capable of implementing it. That's the key, that they can go out and execute a plan.
Gotch feathers it into the corner. Yakovlev takes a bump from Reimer. And now the OAR defenders are hearing the footsteps of that 2-3 system as both forecheckers come in like lightning. Here's Kaprizov. That puck bounced away from him. Seidenberg. Seidenberg goes to Muller. Muller just feathers it forward. Yashin Elitz. Elitz off the shin pads of Kiselevich. Maurer follows it up, and Maurer tried to drag move past Kaprizov. Kaprizov stayed with the puck. Here's Maurer. Maurer joins the fracas, trying to just free it up for Germany. 9.5 remaining in the third period. 1-1 between the OAR and Germany. What a finish we have at Gangneung Hockey Center. Yashin Elitz on the backhand, paddled away by Koshechkin. Yashin Elitz knocked down by Nesterov. Nesterov just trying to freeze the puck. Gusev comes in. Gusev can't get it away from Cahoon. Excellent layers, excellent job on the forecheck by Germany.
That was an excellent shot a moment ago of Snark on the bench, overlooking the play right in front of him there. And the reason why it's fascinating is the intensity of his focus on what's going on out there. He knows that what's coming up here in this remainder of the game is life-defining for him as a coach in this situation.
Telegin with great hustle for the OAR. He breaks up what looked like was going to be an icing call against the OAR, but Telegin wins the battle, the race against Erhoff. Here's Plakta. Plakta can't get there ahead of Voinov. Voinov just plinkoed it forward. It bounced off of Nubles, and now Erhoff. Erhoff with a stretch pass for Plakta. Plakta off his skate, so no icing. Koshechkin plays it around. Nubles keeps it deep for Germany. Here is Fausser. Fausser, a real workhorse for Germany. Gets it to Plakta. Plakta might have been at times the man of the match for Germany against Canada. He had a goal and an assist. Fausser, at the end of a long shift, a little bit tired there, nearly gave it away to Andronov. Here's Kirill Kaprizov. Kaprizov for Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk dancing to the outside and shoots with the gap management, took away the space of Kovalchuk.
The referees have been excellent. They've allowed the players to play the game.
Here's Nesterov. Nesterov, hard angle shot. That seemed to handcuff Austin Birkin, but he made the save. Here's Schutz. Shots on goal. OAR 24, Germany 20. 1-1. It was 1-0 after 20 minutes of play. Germany tied it up in the second. Here comes Hager. Hager! Hager was right through. He got it through the legs of Koshechkin. But then the net comes off. I think Kalinin barreled through. Kalinin is holding that right arm. But what a moment there for Hager. 1-1 OAR and Germany. Tense moments. Third period action. 7.5 to go at Gangneung.
This scene here going to the net for Germany and for OAR trying to recover as it's Kalinin comes in. Almost looks like a battleground as you saw just shrapnel of equipment and body and sticks and just body part flying there as it's Kalinin comes in. Hager, they're trying to, that almost goes through and that's hard. That's hard on the shoulder. Thank goodness that the nets nowadays come off their moorings and positions so much easier than they ever used to before. We have seen some horrific injuries in ice hockey previous to now, how the game has changed and the updating of the technology and how those nets are secured into the post area. Kalinin looks to just be regrouping beside the bench for the moment.
Kalinin hard into the post, trying to stop the progress of Hager. He had his arms wrapped around Hager. There wasn't a penalty call on the play. Kalinin slammed that right elbow and wrist into the post. Brave play by Kalinin. 1-1. Andronov tossed out of the faceoff dot. Kovalchuk will come in. Gotch wins that easily. Here's Seidenberg. Seidenberg with a shot, and it's blocked by Andronov. Andronov with the brave block. Here comes Barabanov. Barabanov out front, and Kovalchuk cannot beat Austin Birkin. What a moment there from the German netminder.
Make no mistake, that's the game saver.
Kovalchuk, 9 out of 10 times you'd bet he'd finish that off. He could not beat Austin Birkin. What a block at one end by Andronov. Andronov with the shot block, and he springs a 2-on-1 forward, but Kovalchuk can't beat Austin Birkin.
Once Kovalchuk saw that Barabanov had the puck, his speed directly towards the goal, trying to be a passing option for him, was as quick as he has skated in this tournament.
Here's Muller. Muller trying to work it free for Reimer. Wolf leaning on Kaprizov. Kaprizov bounces right back up, gets it to Gusev. Gusev with time, space, Gusev scores!
Wow.
Gusev picks the top corner! 2-1 OAR! Nikita Gusev with his third of PyeongChang. That could be the biggest goal of Gusev's career.
A moment ago, we saw the sickle at one end, and then here, coming back from OAR, it's the hammer as they come up high and tight. And I think, as you watch this shot, Danny Austin Birkin thought for a moment that maybe, as he just turned his head, that Gusev wasn't capable of going into a little box that was about 8 inches by 8, as he used Austin Birkin to deflect into that top left of goal. And that is what OAR can do. Wow.
We all know that Gusev can pass the puck, and I think Austin Birkin is playing pass right there. Gusev leads the tournament with 7 assists, but now he turns shooter, and he ripped it off the side of the head of Austin Birkin and into the net. Right back though, Germany score! Dominic Cahoon! Dominic Cahoon has tied it up instantly for Germany!
What is going on? It's unbelievable. This is insanity in the situation here in a gold medal game. No idea how he gets open in front of the goal.
10 seconds between goals. Well, blink and you miss it, because here comes Germany. Alitz, Koshechkin doesn't control the rebound. Alitz pokes it forward, and here is Cahoon. Sublime.
It's staggering how he gets open and how OAR forget about him. And then watch him finish.
Well, you talk about will to win and compete level. There's the definition right there. That is the game tape you watch if you want to talk about compete level when you're up against a team ranked higher than you in the rankings. Doesn't matter if it's globally or in your regional hockey league. That is some kind of compete level from Germany.
I'm genuinely woozy watching that. I don't understand what we just saw.
Voinov understands. Voinov knows the OAR are in trouble right now. They had the lead. They were already thinking about the gold medals, and Cahoon, 10 seconds after Gusev had put the OAR up 2-1, Dominic Cahoon with his second goal of PyeongChang. Cahoon against Canada times the best player on the ice. He was a thorn in the side of Canada in the semifinal, and he has scored the biggest goal of his life in this gold medal final. Here's Datsyuk. Datsyuk with the shot. It's up over the net. Austin Birkin. He was beaten by Gusev, but Germany do not hang their heads. It's 2-2. 10 seconds between the two goals. Here comes Germany again. Masek with the shot right into the chest of big Koshechkin. But Masek, right-handed shot down the left wing, trying to be the hero. Wow, Germany and the OAR tied 2-2.
My heart is in my mouth as we watch this game go up and down the ice. Gusev delivers what we think is the lethal blow as he goes off the side and I don't even think if Austin Birkin fronts up to that shot and he's still anticipating him to shoot it, that it goes off his mask and stays out. I think it's still well placed enough that it's going to go in. But for 10 seconds later, for this chaos of a lack of awareness as to where the danger is going to come from, I have no idea what the OAR were thinking, and I think they don't either.
Dominic Cahoon, his second from Maurer and Elitz, 10 seconds after Gusev had given the OAR a 2-1 lead. Take a deep breath, folks. Hager and Andronov, 2-2 in the men's gold medal game. 5:18 remaining. Gusev and Cahoon with goals 10 seconds apart. Gusev had scored with 6:39 left in this third period. It was 2-1 OAR. It looked like they had one hand on the gold medal. 10 seconds later, Cahoon, here's Masek. 10 seconds later, Cahoon tied it up, and now it's game on with less than 5 minutes to go. Gavrikov will pick it up. Gavrikov, cross ice for Voinov. Voinov had a goal in this game. Started off the scoring with just 0.5 of a second left in the first period. It has been wild and woolly. It has been entertaining, and it has been exactly what you'd want from an Olympic gold medal final. Hearts of champions, spirits of Olympians. Some kind of finish at Gangneung. Telegin. Good play by Reimer. Reimer boxes out on Telegin, and then Reimer's filled in by Gavrikov. But a good play by Reimer. No easy exits at all for OAR out of their own zone. Here's Ehrhoff versus Telegin. Ehrhoff knocked down by Telegin, but Ehrhoff still has control of the puck. Here's the captain, Gotch. Gotch to Nubles. Nubles smartly gains the red line, throws it across the grain for Reimer. They say he doesn't get the red line. And Nubles needs to get center ice there.
They've not learned their lesson, Germany. They haven't. They've iced it again and given an offensive zone faceoff here for OAR. And you hope with 4:03 to go, we have seen insanity already. It's very capable of happening here right off this faceoff for OAR. This was the play for Kalinin earlier when he just does enough to lasso from behind Hager, and he gets himself into all sorts of trouble going into his own goalpost.
4:03 remaining. Big face-off win. The two captains squaring off. Gotch wins the face-off from Datsyuk. Here's Boyle. D-to-D to Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff off the stick of Nubles. Nubles makes sure this time there'll be no icing, and it'll be picked off by Nesterov. Fresh legs over the boards for Marco Sturm's Team Germany. Here's Jonas Muller. Muller steps up, tries to find Cahoon. Cahoon feeling good after that tying goal, and why not? That is something else from Germany. Here's Hordler. Hordler gives it away to Datsyuk, though. You cannot give the puck away when the Datsyuk line is out there, but fight back there from Elitz. Elitz has Cahoon going to the net, goes back to the point. Waiting, dragging back in the net! Goodness gracious, Jonas Muller! Jonas Muller makes it 3-2 Germany!
Do you believe in destiny? Well, if there's such a thing, Germany are arriving right on time. As 3:16 to go, you watch a double toe drag move to outweigh the OAR defense by that man right there. That is the best he's ever executed. And then he finishes it like he's done it many a time before. Watch this play as everybody goes for the initial rush and then waiting. And there I go. I'm going to put it right through the five hole. And look at the mess in the OAR goal.
Jonas Muller had not had a goal in PyeongChang. What a time to get your first goal at the Olympic Games. It's 3-2 Germany. They trailed 1-0. They trailed 2-1. And with 3:10 on the clock in this gold medal showdown, they lead 3-2. What can OAR do now? Here's Seidenberg for Krupp. Krupp gets it to the line, dumped in by Fausser, and now it's simple hockey time if you're Germany. Keep executing that dump and chase play. Keep getting in on the forecheck. A 1-3-1 for Germany now. One man in, three guys across the neutral zone, and one man back. This is going to be difficult for the OAR. It's going to be special. It's going to have to be special. That 1-3-1 system, difficult at Marco Sturman, poised with a lead. Here's Grigorenko. Grigorenko sifts it in. When will Koshechkin get out of the net? Shoots like a wrecking ball. Boyle, Masek, out into the neutral zone, and here's Hager. Hager working so hard between the blue lines for Germany.
Penalty coming, and it's going against OAR. They just hit the self-destruct button. As there's going to be a tripping call against, it went on in front of their own bench when bodies were coming and going like it was the Moscow Central Station.
Kalinin for tripping and the furrowed brow of Oleg Znarek. Kalinin, well, there's a good point to this. Kalinin, it looked like he might have had a broken arm the way he crashed into the net earlier, but Kalinin now, at least he's healthy, but now he's taking a bad penalty.
Pretty sure those guys watching don't think it's so good. It's incredible what's going on here. If it's going to be what looks like it might be for Germany, it's going to have to be something incredible like we've witnessed, because these players for Germany right now are writing history.
It looked good for the OAR. 6:39 left in this third period. Gusev with a highlight reel goal, but 10 seconds after that, Dominic Cahoon and Jonas Muller. 3 minutes after that, a 3-2 lead, Germany. And now a power play for Germany. They're 0-for-1, but this is basically a license to kill off a minute 50 of 2 minutes with the 5-on-4. Here's Cahoon. Cahoon looking to put an exclamation point on this gold medal game. Here's Seidenberg. Back to Cahoon. Cahoon in front looking for a wolf, but it bounced off Datsyuk's shot from Seidenberg. Again, Datsyuk with the block. Hordler to Datsyuk, or away from Datsyuk. As Datsyuk was watching Seidenberg, Seidenberg will just lift it into the far corner for Germany. 1.5 minutes to go. Most of that will be spent on the power play for Germany, but here comes Tillagen. Tillagen gains the line, swoops outside. Tillagen tries to go to the front, but it's blocked by Schütz. Good play by Schütz. Tillagen desperately trying to find some offense shorthanded. Zub trying to poke it away from Seidenberg. Seidenberg is knocked down. Cahoon comes in, 1:10 remaining. Empty net. So it's 5-on-5. They've pulled Koshechkin. Here's Kaprizov. Kaprizov out front, collapsing in front. Schütz and Seidenberg do a good job against Zub. Here's Gusev!
Oh my goodness.
Gusev! Are you kidding me? Nikita Gusev with 55.5 seconds remaining, his second of the period. Unbelievable!
I have never seen a hockey game like this in this type of situation. It's hard to comprehend what's going on. They were shorthanded. They pull the goaltender 5-on-5, and Gusev has done the double dirty on Germany on a backhand that slices into the same spot he scored but a few moments ago. It's beyond. It is beyond.
Watch the bench and look at Znarek. Not an emotional guy. Well, saving the bacon right there, Gusev. Wow, he has been a playmaker, and Kalinin, it does look like a bad arm, and it's good that he came back and played, but then he takes the penalty, and I think Kalinin will owe Nikita Gusev a steak dinner, because that was a shorthanded goal technically for the OAR, and Nikita Gusev with his second goal of the period, fourth of the competition, just 55.5 seconds remaining on the clock.
So they've taken a timeout now, OAR, because Kozetskin's going to go back into the goal. And here we go. There still is the power play, of course, for Germany. And it's 45 seconds remaining. Watch this again, though. It's what you make movies about, what we're watching here right now.
When heroes step up and become heroes, well, put the cape on Gusev, because they're less than a minute away from heartache. And Gusev shorthanded puts the puck to twine, and it never felt so fine for the OAR. Power play continues for Germany. 45 seconds to see if they can come right back They have scored a goal within 10 seconds of a goal against in this game. When Gusev made it 2-1, Cahoon came back and made it 2-2 10 seconds after that Gusev goal. Can Germany find some more magic with 40 seconds left on the clock? Here's Reimer. Reimer to Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff to Reimer, shoots, is in front. Drifts in behind the goal now, shoots. Hager. Hager has it bounce away from him. He had Plokta in front, and now Andronov plows into Hager. Here's Plokta. Plokta to shoots. Reimer's wide open over on the left flank, less than 20 seconds remaining. Here's Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff with the shot deflected by Plokta, but it was deflected high and wide. Here's Schütz. Schütz trying to go back door to Reimer with 9.5 seconds remaining. Looked like Voinov got a stick on that, but, well, you want something special in your gold medal game. How about this one?
The interesting thing is, not every gold medal game has the type of engagement that we have in the building here right now. The crowd are responding. Yeah, there's a lot of Russian support, there's a lot of German support, but there's a lot of neutral support, and everybody is enthralled.
We're enthralled in the commentary box. We hope you're enthralled at home. This has been special. And there's another special moment coming at some point, whether it's in this 9.5 seconds or whether it's going to be in the overtime. Gangneung Hockey Center has come alive. On the biggest stage come the biggest of moments. And how about Muller and Gusev trading goals, go-ahead goals and tying goals here in the late stages of the third stanza. Big face-off now for Cahoon versus the legend, Datsyuk. Datsyuk wins the face-off, but a jam play for Yashin Alits.
Wow.
Alits, even though Datsyuk won the face-off, somehow Yashin Alits gets a scoring chance, and the buzzer will sound. 60 minutes of the most incredible hockey game you're ever to see in this sort of situation. And that man, Nikita Gusev, with just 55.5 seconds remaining, saves the ambitions for a gold medal for the OAR.
This game is absolutely intoxicating. You do not need anything to bring the super high that both of these sides will be feeling now for different reasons as we now reset and we will go to overtime. It'll be a 20-minute period. We will have an entire intermission here as the ice resurfacing machines go to the ice. And you've got to wonder what both sets of fans feel for different reasons. But you know what? It's game on still. And it's just been as good as you could want to have.
Germany and the Olympic athlete from Russia's squad tied 3-3 after 60 minutes of regulation play at Gangneung Hockey Center. Overtime coming up.
Gangneung Hockey Center may be nicknamed the Hockey Cathedral, the Global Hockey Cathedral, because all eyes that are watching hockey at this point right now are watching this game. And Gusev takes the lead here for OAR with what at the time looked like, because it was so fine and it was so well placed, you thought that's the kind of goal that shows you what the OAR are all about. And then within 10 seconds, a almighty collapse in front of OAR's goal. And that was about as significant as what happened in the late 80s and early 90s, talking about a collapse as things all of a sudden it's 2-2 and then a lead. Well, this is still the 2-2 goal. I have no idea how, again, he was alone in front of the OAR goal. And it carries on, and then this layered play where you watch a toe drag from a player who hasn't scored a goal in his tournament. He does it like he's, in fact, Pavel Datsyuk, except he's Müller for Germany, who's got Datsyuk totally outstretched and prone, and he's got Kazetskin, the OAR keeper, looking like he's got a campfire with his own goalie stick on the top of his neck.
Just 55.5 seconds remaining here, and this is something special. Gusev already with one goal in the game, and how about that for clutch? Less than a minute to go. The gold medal looked like it was going historically for the first time to Germany, but Nikita Gusev, so often the playmaker, so often the assist leader, becomes the big scorer for the OAR.
It's so dramatic that we have to take a little bit of a break now as we will prepare for the overtime period. Do not go anywhere. You're watching it all unfold here live. This is a historic moment.
Well, there are exciting moments in sports, and then there are otherworldly moments in sports. This would qualify as the latter. You can look up and down that roster and see the chaos and the magnificence of that third period. It was special.
Yeah, it was. It was so much more than anybody could have anticipated. I think the way the game started with Germany, the way they were able to stay with it, and they didn't score first, obviously. You know, it's setting up to be, whether it's a Germany or OAR, to win this game now in overtime as we look back at the third period goals and 10 shots for Germany. It's just the quickness of response after a goal conceded. It's the whole elevation of each other's games, both of them. Now, Germany has played better in this game than maybe OAR have, and OAR we know can be that much better when they want to be. But Germany have created this scenario because they've been the hockey team capable of controlling OAR in this tournament, in this final game, and then the gold medal game. And what's so impressive about Germany, even when they got hit hard with that goal coming in and being scored against them by Nikita Gusev, they come back 10 seconds later and equalize it, and then they go ahead. You know, it's just, and how taken, like the moment and way it was taken by Müller, Jonas Müller, and his first goal, and the way he took it was just, it was scintillating.
Well, let's get people caught up. You might be just dipping in for this overtime session. It was 1-0 OAR after 20 minutes of play, and that's where the drama started. Just 0.5 of a second left when Voinov made it 1-0. Felix Schütz tied it up for Germany in period two, and then cue forward to 6 minutes and 39 seconds left in the third period. Gusev, look what he like would be the winning goal, his third. But 10 seconds later after that, Dominic Cahoon tied it up for Germany. And then 3 minutes later, Jonas Müller, his first goal of the competition, and it was 3-2 Germany. They had trailed 1-0, 2-1, and all of a sudden it looked like they were a few minutes away from the gold medal. And then a shorthanded goal with 55.5 seconds remaining, and the goaltender pulled for the OAR. Gusev gets his second. You can see he's got a spring in his step, no doubt about it. Second goal of the game, fourth of the competition, Zub and Kaprizov with less than a minute to go. And that is how we are heading to overtime at Gangneung Hockey Center in this brilliant gold medal game. A brilliant gold medal performance on both sides of the puck.
It has been. Nobody can change history now. What's done is done. We're in overtime, and it's a one-shot wonder. Who's got it? That's what we are waiting to see.
Germany outshoot the OAR in the second period, or in the third period, 10-7. They both get two in the third stanza. 25 saves for Danny Ostenberken. Koshechkin with 21 saves in the nets for OAR. Datsyuk versus Cahoon, and Datsyuk wins the opening faceoff. 4-on-4 in overtime, of course, at Gangneung Hockey Center. Plenty of room to roam on both sides of the puck. Germany have never won gold in their Olympic history. The OAR looking to end a 26-year drought of standing atop the podium. Here's Voinov. Voinov for Datsyuk. Datsyuk outside of Hordler. Datsyuk has always had those slick hands. Hordler stays with the body and not the puck. Good play by Hordler. Knows who he's playing against, realizes he can't watch the puck because Datsyuk will turn you inside out.
That's the reason why we call him the Magic Man. He can beat you standing still, and he can beat you once and then pull it back around you again just for twice, just for fun.
Voinov, who started off the scoring with just half a second remaining in the opening stanza. And it's been dramatic, fast-paced, and at times hectic. But the word that keeps coming to my mind is special. We're witnessing something special at PyeongChang 2018. Boyle, Germany have already upset both the gold and silver medalists from Sochi in 2014. They beat Sweden in the quarters and Canada in the semis. Can they win that first ever gold medal? Here's Boyle. Nesterov for Kiselevich. Kiselevich being watched by Masek. Masek is the type of guy that if he gets a shot from 20 feet, this could be over. There comes Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk also a guy that if he gets a shot from 20 feet, it could be over. So both sets of defenders playing and giving respect to the likes of Masek and Kovalchuk. Here comes Kaprizov. Kaprizov trying to barrel forward. Good poke check there from Austin Birkin. Tension in their own end for Germany, but they just calm it down through Reimer. He had the overtime winning goal against Sweden. Can he double dip? Here's Alitz. Alitz carried into the corner by Kaprizov. Here's Zubarev. 3-3 OAR in Germany. Full house at Gangneung Hockey Center. Overtime has started off quick. Both teams ready for action, but it's important to note that Germany have won four straight games and three of them have come in extra time.
Well, they know how to win tight hockey games. It's now with some space, OAR with speed.
Here's Barabanov. Barabanov trying to go around Seidenberg. Seidenberg was the hero against Switzerland with an overtime goal. Here's Barabanov trying to turn Seidenberg inside out. Seidenberg stays with the man, doesn't even look at the puck. Barabanov, though, squeaks by. Barabanov with excellent play on the wall. Seidenberg plays off of Barabanov. Voinov with the shot. It was a cannon, but it was wide. Gavrikov for Grigorenko. Barabanov goes to the front of the net. Grigorenko trying to win that board battle against Hordler. Here's Gavrikov with the shot. It's deflected in front. Barabanov tries to square up, but Gotch comes in and quiets it down for Germany.
You know what's interesting about the way this building has developed over the course of the hockey game? We weren't sure entirely just how, whether it would be an entire sellout, but this is now taken its own life as members from Olympic Park are coming in. Here's Germany again.
Here's Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff leading the way in ice time. 23 minutes and 25 seconds time on ice through the regulation time for the assistant captain Ehrhoff. Here's Kiselevich. Kiselevich, back pressure from Fausser, and Fausser wins a 50-50 puck and now comes forward. Here comes Fausser. He's got Boyle coming in from the point. Boyle won at the puck, but Fausser was being watched defensively by Kiselevich. Fausser all the way back. Austin Birkin taps it forward for Ehrhoff. Ehrhoff also has four shots on goal in the game for Germany. He's done it all from the back end. Here's Masek. Masek trying to just snake by on that left side, but Andronov and Zub had other ideas. Here's Zubarev. A quick 4 minutes gone in overtime. Kovalchuk to Andronov. Andronov trying to push off of Moritz Muller, but that will come all the way back as both teams, you don't want a mistake here, and this could be a mistake from the OAR.
Yeah, they've taken an icing here, and you can see the question of it, but ultimately, you just got to get back to the task at hand. But this building feels like a powder keg. It's ready to erupt.
4-on-4 action, of course, in overtime, and guys like Ilya Kovalchuk love 4-on-4 play. Andronov versus Cahoon. Andronov with a face-off win, an important face-off win for the OAR. Cahoon has been especially good for Germany in the face-off dot. Here's Zub. Zub wants to wheel it, wants to build up from the back end. Pressured by Maurer, though, he goes to Zubarev. And Zubarev has nowhere to go. He had Hordler and Cahoon managing the space. He has to ice the puck again with 15:27 remaining in overtime.
This situation becomes amplified because A, we're in overtime, and B, we're 4-on-4. You can't keep icing the puck and putting pressure on yourself. You're already deep, you're already tired, you already played as many games as you have in a short space of time. You gotta make the right decisions.
And on an icing play like that, the offending team, the icing team, can't change, so heavy legs, and Germany brings out fresh legs.
This is savvy over there right now by OAR, as they have just gone to get some adjustment of skate. They're buying time for the players on the ice. They got away with it, but it's exactly what they're doing. That's gamesmanship right there from the OAR.
Smart play by Telegen, saying he's blown an edge, but I think that's more of a 10-second respite for the players on the ice. Good play by Telegen. Reimer can't win the faceoff. Kovalchuk does a good job in the faceoff dot. Here's Artem Zub. Shoots Cahoon and Muller for Germany. Voinov and two goals from Gusev for the OAR. We are in overtime. Sudden death overtime. 4-on-4 at Gangneung Hockey Center. Krupp with the long stick just bunted it forward, but Jonas Muller was offside, so he had to let the puck go. Voinov picks it up. Here's Zub for Voinov. Voinov tucked in behind big Kashetskin, waiting for the perfect breakout. He wants to go to Gusev, but I think Yashin Alits knows that, so Alits is boxing out to that side. But here's Gusev. Gusev gives way to Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk snuck in behind everybody, and Austin Birkin knows who's barreling down on him. 5 goals in the competition for Kovalchuk. Austin Birkin wasn't going to mess around.
Oh, no, you wouldn't, as you had a good look there at the... There's four different pucks. There was a women's puck, a men's puck. There was a gold medal men's and a gold medal women's. That gold medal men's puck, if it's scored by Germany, could be worth more than gold.
Face off to the left of Austin Birkin. Christian Ehrhoff, look at the eyes. You would not know that he's played almost 25 minutes in this game. Back to the point, Voinov, Gavrikov. Gavrikov around the horn for Gusev, who has 2 goals and both of the spectacular variety for the OAR, but he's dispossessed by Schutz. Schutz had the opening goal for Team Germany. Gusev with a good play, picking the pocket of Ehrhoff. Gusev trying to get it back to Gavrikov, and here comes Gotch. Gotch has space down the right wing. He's waiting for reinforcements. Dumps it in. Koshetskin paddles it away as Schutz comes forward. Here's Schutz trying to get it back to Gotch. Good veteran savvy by Gotch. He didn't rush anything, and now there's a chance to post up, but it's poked away by Gavrikov. Good play by Gavrikov, but it was veteran savvy by Gotch coming forward for Germany. Here's Boyle. Boyle rolls it up on Koshetskin. Nesterov, first player there. Kisilevich dumps it all the way down. Hordler let it go. So that's a crafty play by Hordler, but the linesman says no icing.
Both teams and every player very sensible and effective right now. There isn't any obvious vulnerability for either side. They are both playing well.
Here's Plakta. Plakta beaten to the puck by Kovalchuk. Here comes Ilya Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk in. Kovalchuk denied by Austin Birkin. He had the game and the gold medal on his stick, and Austin Birkin said, no way, Ilya Kovalchuk. What a stop by the German goalkeeper.
And that save by Austin Birkin has allowed his nation to still be competing for a gold medal, or otherwise it would be silver you're tasting today. Watch this play against Kovalchuk. He's done the first bit, and it's just missed by ever so slightly the top of the pad, and enough extension from Austin Birkin to keep German hopes alive.
Austin Birkin was down but not out. He got the pad up, but you'd think 99% of the time Kovalchuk would put it home there. He could not. Here's Zub. Zub for Gusev. Gusev with a nice move at the line. Stutter step. Goes across for Zub. Zub has his head on a swivel. Datsuk in front. Zubarev, the other defenseman, but it's Gusev. Gusev trying to find a lane to penetrate. Gusev with the shot. Looking for the hat trick and some history. Missed the net. Datsuk pushed into the boards by Hordler. Hordler just trying to freeze Datsuk in that corner. Zubarev. Zubarev to Zub. Zub all the way around the low kick plate looking for Gusev. Datsuk wins the puck, puts a shoulder into Hordler, but Hordler stands his ground and angles off Datsuk. Fouser for Hordler. 12:35 remaining in sudden death overtime. The crowd on the edge of their seats. Here comes Cahoon. Cahoon with speed, trying to go between the legs of Gavrikov. Gavrikov just kicked that off to the side, and Telegen takes over for the OAR. Here's Gavrikov, intercepted by Maurer. Good play by Maurer. He pulls down Telegen. Both referees keep their arm down. Gavrikov wins the puck back for Voinov. Voinov, saucer pass up to Telegen. Telegen tried to go hard up the wall, but it's intercepted, and
put forward by Moritz Müller. Here comes Voinov. Voinov. Voinov turns and fires. He was trying to go across the body, glove side, but he missed the net. Here comes Masek. Masek battling with Grigorenko. Masek wins the puck, gets it to Hager. Here's Hager. Hager shoots, and Koshechkin closes the wickets. Hager trying to go five-hole. Hager complaining of a quick whistle there, but it will be a face-off deep in the OAR zone.
And maybe the quick whistle, because it looked like otherwise it was going to get a little bit frantic in front of OAR's goal. But Hager, again, like we saw with the Müller goal, looking for that little bit of a toe drag in. Here it is, Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk can make the call in and get the gold medals just delivered to his boys, and he can't get through.
That's a big stop by Austin Birkin. That's a life-changing stop by Austin Birkin to keep this game going. Remember that stop if Germany find a way through. Here's Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk dances past, shoots. Here's Ilya Kovalchuk with purpose and precision. Down the right side, tried to find the trailer, Zubarev. Kicks back to Zub. Here's Boyle. Boyle pushed hard into the wall. Kovalchuk opened up and tried to reach for that, but it shoots, chasing it down. He comes shoulder to shoulder with Zub. That gives Kovalchuk time to twirl back into the OAR zone. 11-11 remaining in the overtime session. Here's Zubarev. Zubarev shoulder to shoulder with Reimer. Reimer has a huge overtime goal in this competition. He eliminated Sweden. Here's Boyle for Yashin Elits. Elits tries to get cute around Datsyuk. And there's one thing you might want to do is try and get cute around Pavel Datsyuk. Here's Gusev. Gusev tries to go cross ice, and there's a penalty coming up. Koshechkin trying to get to the bench for the 6-on-5 situation, but Yashin Elits will touch up. Power play coming up, OAR.
They have taken a few penalties today, Germany. None more dangerous than this one, as Datsyuk just does what he does, and it comes up and catches him, and then he gestures that he has been caught, and the reality is, yeah, he did get caught, and he's been able to direct the attention of the referees by bringing his hand up to his face, and now there's a high-sticking penalty. But what Datsyuk did there in his movement and in his deception was basically create advantage for OAR. They are now 4-3 in the extra time period, and a golden goal, if you were going to bet on one, is now awaiting.
Germany tried to get cute in the neutral zone there against Datsyuk. He invented the word cute on the puck, so wins the puck back and then draws the penalty, and now he's out there to add insult to injury, taking the face-off against Gotch. Datsyuk wins it to Gusev. Kaprizov will drift off to the flank. Voinov, the lone point man. Here's Datsyuk. Datsyuk off the post! Datsyuk with a ripper of a backhand. Looked like he had the game won. Nothing doing. The drama continues at Gangneung. Here's Gusev. Gusev to Voinov. Back to Gusev. Fakes it. Voinov to Kaprizov all around the circle here. Gusev. Gusev to Kaprizov! What's your favorite color, OAR? It's gold! Kaprizov sends the bench into celebration. A 26-year drought is over. Kapril Kaprizov, the overtime hero for the Olympic athlete from Russia squad. Power play goal in overtime.
It's devastating, and it's just as everybody who knows anything about this tournament will tell you, it's what OAR are capable of. They went off the bar, and then they went into the twine. They will win the gold medal in men's ice hockey 4-3 over Germany, and they had to do it in extra time.
Well, the celebration's just beginning for the OAR, and tears for Team Germany. It might take a few days. This will hurt for Germany, but in a few days, a few weeks' time, they'll know the magnitude of what they've achieved here. They pushed the best team in this tournament on paper, and at times on the ice, they showed flashes of brilliance, the OAR, but Germany pushed them to the distance. And it took 9:40 into overtime for the OAR to finally wrestle that gold away from Germany.
This was a game for the ages, and you know what I like seeing there was in the midst of the exhale from OAR. They made sure Snark to turn around and acknowledge the German coaching staff and shake their hand. Watch it again. Gusev, he had been the wonder man all day. He leaves it over there, and the rest is history as Kaprizov just catches it. You see the flex of the stick. He gets enough of it. He doesn't probably need as much speed. It's the elevation there. The elevation is enough. And you see Datsyuk. Datsyuk roaring like a lion. And there he is. Finally, a member of the Triple Gold Club is Pavel Datsyuk. He almost did it himself, the shot previous. And whoa. But they know they got a let off there. And the sun was shining over Russia today.
Fifth goal of the competition for Kirill Kaprizov, assisted by Gusev and Voinov. How about the game by Nikita Gusev? Two goals and two assists. Absolutely heroic for the OAR, as there are tears of joy and some disappointment, but this is a nice moment. Marco Sturm, no doubt, telling Team Germany how proud he is of the way they played and conducted themselves in PyeongChang.
It was a massive journey forward for Germany, from not being in Sochi 4 years ago and then going through all of the best except just at the final gate, can't get through. The team that was favored to take gold here, they made it more interesting than any of us could have expected, and the game was more than a gold medal game.
This is what's great about ice hockey. Yeah, you battle, you take lumps out of each other for 69 minutes and 40 seconds. One team heartbroken, the other team elated, but you still meet at center ice and battle. Tears in the eyes of Marcel Gotch. In a few days' time, he'll realize what the accomplishment has been and how proud they are, but it's nice to see the handshake after a really good battle here in the gold medal game.
Yeah, you know, I like seeing handshakes. I like the full regard for one another as the game warrants. You know, the game of ice hockey, I believe, warrants the situation, the stage that went on here. It warrants that full respect. It's almost a little bit like they just went through a seven-game series.
Well, Ilya Kovalchuk had a chance on a partial breakaway. Went to the backhand, couldn't get it over the pad of Austin Birkin, but Kaprizov on a power play, 4-on-3 situation, was not going to miss.
The affection being displayed by OAR right now for Germany, you know what that tells me? It tells me not only do they have a world of respect for Germany, but they have, well, it's humanity right there. They have the humility to know they almost had silver just the same.
What a tournament from Danny Austenberg, and he can leave Gangneung Hockey Center with his head held high. You could see what it meant to the fans. The building erupted, you said it earlier, it was almost a powder keg or a cauldron here, and the roof did come off at Gangneung Hockey Center when Kaprizov dented the twine for his fifth goal. Most important goal in the career of Kirill Kaprizov. He's the youngest member of the forward lines here, and Kirill Kaprizov plays for CSKA Moscow. He's a Minnesota draft pick in 2015. Big future for Kirill Kaprizov.
Oh, of course. There's so much talent in this lineup here for OAR. But again, I'm going to acknowledge the scenes. Now, Marco Sturm delivered the directive to his side to make sure and every single man to a man came right through that OAR bench and shook hands with every single one of them. There is a massive amount of respect going on here as we wait for the medal celebrations. This was the opening goal.
What a gold medal matchup we have witnessed at Gangneung Hockey Center. Two goals each in period three to send us to overtime, and we thought it couldn't get any better after that third period. We were wrong, because overtime was edge of your seat stuff. Gusev with two goals and two assists for the OAR. That's one of your stars stepping up at the right moment. A four-point performance from Nikita Gusev. Shots on goal, 30-25 in favor of the OAR. None of these stats will matter on either side of the puck. The big stat, though, is that one power play goal, as it was Kirill Kaprizov with the overtime winner with the man advantage, his fifth, assisted by Gusev. Gusev with an astounding eight assists in the tournament. Voinov with his fourth helper. And Kirill Kaprizov absolutely sending the OAR bench into a rapturous celebration. Look at Oleg Znarek. He's got the phone out, taking some selfies. Good to see Oleg Znarek with a smile on his face.
Well, I think they're even chatting with somebody on FaceTime, and it's live, so a personal connection there. You know, we have this media all-star team and MVP selections that we contribute to as members, and, you know, this game had a big bearing on how we would select the first and second team all-stars in this tournament.
You'd have to have Danny Austin-Birkin down as maybe the MVP. He might not be the all-star goalie, that might be Koshetsko, but maybe the most valuable player in this tournament was Danny Austin-Birkin. Think about that save he made in overtime on Kovalchuk to even give them a chance to continue on with the overtime session.
Yeah.
And there he is, I mean, sweat dripping off the brow. That's a tough turnout, 69 minutes and 40 seconds of tense hockey in a winner-take-all gold medal game. Jonas Muller thought he had the winning goal, didn't he? He put Germany up 3-2, you can feel for him, the heart breaks for him, but it was Gusev with 55.5 seconds remaining sending the game to overtime. And well, Shesterkin was good, made some key saves, especially in period two. Some big stops by Shesterkin. It was 1-0 OAR after 20 minutes of play. It was 1-1 after 40 minutes, and then a four-goal barrage, two for each side in period three.
It's interesting watching Timo Pielmeier, the German backup keeper, didn't play today. He's almost going around and consoling his teammates and speaking to them and re-encouraging them and helping to put things into perspective, like he's a counselor. And it shows you the dynamic of how close his team is for Germany, how much they care about each other, and how much equally they understood what the moment was.
Well, you don't upset Sweden. You don't upset Canada if you don't care about each other, stick together as a group, and listen to your coach singing off the same hymn sheet. And that was Germany to a T. And they were within a whisker. They were within a shot of upsetting the OAR. There's no doubt about it. And I think the OAR, you talk about the respect and the compassion, the humility they're showing, it's because they knew they were in a whisker of another upset from Team Germany. And when that man, Jonas Muller, made it 3-2, everyone, even the OAR bench, thought this could be it. This could be another big victory for Germany. But it was Gusev playing the hero and sending us to overtime.
And I think that's part of the reason, well, naturally the reason, why Muller is showing the emotion that he's become overcome by what's happened here. Because you can't help when you pull off the first goal of the tournament in such a grand stage to kind of think to yourself, you know what, this is destiny. This is something that's greater than all of ourselves having a hand to play in it. And then it gets taken away from you, and it's just more than you can fathom.
Canada received their bronze medals right after their victory over the Czech Republic, so it will be a two-team celebration at Gangneung Hockey Center. Germany feeling the emotions now. It's a good point by you. I think after the battle, after the adrenaline, the emotions, it hits you. We were that close, boys. But also, who 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, would have said Germany would win a medal?
Who would have said that after a second game of this tournament? They lost the first two games, you know? Played against Sweden, played against Finland, and everybody's thinking, well, they're just going to get run out of town. And then they had other ideas that nobody else knew were available to them, really, as far as coming into this tournament and putting a dent into it, and then a dent all the way to the gold medal game and pushing the favorites right to overtime. I think you made an impact.
A difficult notion, perhaps, in the back of the minds of Germany. They played in four overtime games in this competition. They won three, and unfortunately, they couldn't get the fourth one here. They were overtime and shootout kings in PyeongChang, and I know they won't look at it, but they would have had the belief going into overtime that we're going to get this done.
Well, we had a thought that if you won three times in extra time at the Olympic Games, that that might be good enough to take you all the way and win your last game. But, you know, it's it really was a marvelous hockey game for all the right reasons. And it was just a tremendous spectacle and showcase.
The crowd lingering. They want to see these medals for both Germany and the Olympic athlete from Russia squad. Austin Birkin, for my money, maybe the most valuable player to his team. They're not here. They don't even actually get by Sweden in the overtime game without Austin Birkin.
No, they don't.
He made some big saves against Canada, so he might be disappointed that Kaprizov ripped that power play goal, the winning goal, past him, but there was nothing he could do on a 4-on-3 situation. Too much ice for OAR and too much skill out there.
That's the challenge with the overtime, is the removal of the player that actually started to favor OAR as soon as that situation went on. And they played one last game than Germany too, so fatigue, you know, I didn't really see fatigue becoming an issue for Germany. I thought at the end of the third period there was some heavy legs and a little bit of staggering steps. But anyhow, and I'm not saying in this situation necessarily the best team won. I think that OAR found a way from, it looked like they were going to be claiming a silver medal, to pull a little bit of a magic trick here.
Kovalchuk thought he had ended it about three shifts prior to Kaprizov. He broke in, he showed great poise and speed, but again, the left pad of Austin Birkin almost reminded me of Dominic Hasek, the way he flapped down and got the pad up into the air about 3-4 inches off the air. You think you have the roof of the net, and you don't. And that's the type of performance it was from Danny Ostenberg. Well, there's a steely glare from Marcel Gotch. 636 NHL games played in the career of Marcel Gotch. This is his third Olympics. Nikita Gusev, 2 goals and 2 assists for Gusev. Leads the KHL in assists, right? But really stepped up as a goal scorer in the third period here. Really, when the OAR needed a hero, he became that goal-scoring hero. And there's Marco Sturm and the German coaching staff and backroom staff. They had a magnificent tournament.
For the OAR, these Russian athletes, this is to get a gold medal for them. You can see it in their eyes. It's a little bit like winning the hockey lottery. I think it does mean more generally to them than winning a Stanley Cup in the National Hockey League. I think that's such a general statement to make. It's always constantly evaluated to different hockey people, but this is a monumental moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the Ice Hockey Men's Tournament.
지금부터 아이스 하키 남자 종목의 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
Well, here come the spoils of victory and to a lesser extent for Germany, but they will remember in a few weeks' time what it took to get to this gold medal game. When you're a kid playing road hockey, pond hockey, playing for your traveling team, to think you'll wear an Olympic medal wearing your country's colors, what a moment for Team Germany and some legends out there to present the medals.
Monsieur René Fazel, Suisse, membre du Comité international olympique.
Mr. René Fazel, Switzerland, member of the International Olympic Committee.
Suisse, René Fazel, 국제 올림픽 위원회 집행위원입니다.
Madame Britta Heidemann, Allemagne, membre du Comité international olympique.
Mrs. Britta Heidemann, Germany, member of the International Olympic Committee, Olympian, one gold medal, two silver medals.
독일의 브리타 하이데만, 국제올림픽위원회 위원으로 올림피안이며 금메달 1개, 은메달 2개를 수상한 경력이 있습니다.
Accompanied by
다음은 시상품 시상자입니다.
Monsieur Vladislav Kretiak, Fédération de Russie, membre du Conseil de la Fédération Internationale de Hockey sur Glace, Olympia.
Considered by many the best goalkeeper to ever play the game out of Russia, Vladislav Kretiak. An absolute legend between the pipes. Legend has it he hated to get scored on, even in practice, would battle in practice like it was an overtime game, and nice to see him out there on the ice.
Monsieur Franz Reindl, Allemagne, membre du Conseil de la Fédération Internationale de Hockey sur Glace, Olympia, une médaille de bronze.
Franz Reindl, bronze medal.
Germany.
In his career,
Ice Hockey Federation Council member, Olympian, one bronze medal.
독일의 프란스 라인들, 국제 아이스하키 연맹회 이사회 위원으로 올림피안이며 동메달 한 개를 수상한 경력이 있습니다.
It's interesting seeing the emotion of both of the respective IOC members there, one from Germany, one from Russia. As now the presentations of the medals to Germany.
Daryl Boyle, 340 DEL games played magnificently in this game. Brooks Masek, two big power play goals in the competition. Brooks Masek, former Detroit Red Wings pick. Marcus Kink was a wrecking ball at times on the forecheck, and he really gave the OAR some troubling moments in their own zone in the opening period. Plakta, magnificent against Canada in the semifinals. Danny Austin-Birkin, certainly the most valuable player at times in the competition. They will not be celebrating being a part of this showcase game without Austin-Birkin. There's Reimer. Reimer was in the penalty box for that goal against, but remember, he had the winning goal against Sweden. A hero at times in this competition.
Make no mistake of it.
No mistake of the situation here. It looks like Germany have taken perspective of what's gone on here. They still are the most successful international team from Germany in the history of ice hockey.
There's Gerrit Fouser. Look at that lower Gerrit right lip. Fouser. Blocked a shot with his face. I said it earlier, I'll say it again, because to win at this level of hockey, you have to be brave, especially as an underdog. And Gerrit Fouser was willing to block shots with his face to get to this gold medal game.
Patrick Hager,
three goals and four assists to lead Germany in scoring. Magnificent. There's Timo Pielmeier. Interesting for you to note how good he was with his teammates in defeat.
Felix Schütz.
Schütz had the opening goal in this game for Marcel Germany, tying the game up at 1-1. And there's the captain, Marcel Gotch. His third Olympics, perhaps his last Olympics, who knows, but a silver medal for Gotch.
Leon Ferdel.
Ferdel didn't play in this game.
David Wolf.
But a big part of this club did have one goal in the competition. Wolf came back from that big hit by Gilbert Brulé and was instrumental in the game today.
Marcel Nobles.
Nobles, a former Philadelphia Flyers draft pick, had a big goal in the game against Switzerland.
It's a very personal exchange going on here. It feels like it's just a very mutual and reciprocated exchange between the delegates and the players, the coaches watching, and equally OAR watching Tretiak presenting these medals to the German athletes. It feels like there's just a real understanding amongst everybody just what went on here today.
Well, Franz Reindl played for Germany, won a bronze medal with Germany. Vladislav Tretiak, so dominant when he played
for the big red machine. So there's a personal aspect. They know what this team went through. They know what it took to win a silver medal. And make no mistake, they won that silver medal. Some people say you lose gold and win silver, but I don't look at it that way. This is a moment in time and their best finish at an Olympic Games, and they should be very proud, Team Germany. And now they will end a 26-year drought. The last gold medal coming in 1992. Telegen, considered the best defensive forward in the KHL. Bozyak in the KHL's all-time leading point getter. Took a lesser role here and didn't complain about it. It was sometimes on the third and fourth line, but it took a full team effort for the OAR. Well, the triple gold club finally for Pavel Datsyuk. Two Stanley Cups, World Championship gold, and now that elusive gold medal for the Magic Man. He completes the cycle as a triple gold club member.
His shot went off the crossbar early in that power play sequence. And other players just don't think to take that shot like he did.
Kablukov did not play against Slovakia, was a healthy scratch, got back in after the first game loss to Slovakia, never relinquished his spot. Played really well, Kablukov. One of the 15 members of SKA St. Petersburg, Yegor Yakovlev.
Alexei Marchenko, Bogdan Kiselevich.
Ilya Kovalchuk, so proud this moment. Said they were here for one thing and one thing only, and that journey now completed for Ilya Kovalchuk. Here's the overtime hero, Kirill Kaprizov, his fifth goal of the competition, an overtime winner. He will forever skate as a legend in this game.
There is the big keeper. He got it done. He played as he needed to play. And equally, wow, the last player here in line today.
Two goals and two assists. They do not get to overtime without Gusev's goal with 55.5 seconds remaining. It was spectacular up under the bar. 4 points in a gold medal game, that's rising to a challenge, isn't it? And Nikita Gusev did that in flying colors, and the color will be gold. A moment in time as an athlete to not soon forget, as a broadcaster, as a fan, as a coach. And a special, special game at Gangneung Hockey Center to wind down a sublime men's ice hockey tournament. The Olympic athlete from Russia squad, gold, ending a 26-year drought. Germany with their best ever finish
at an Olympic Games, and Canada, a bronze medal, bravely beating the Czech Republic in the bronze medal game. But here's the moment all athletes dream of, that famous picture at center ice with the logo, with your teammates, with that gold medal. And the OAR, the coaching staff, all the family, friends, the backroom staff in behind. A special, special moment. Pavel Datsyuk becoming the 28th member of the Triple Gold Club, a Stanley Cup champion in 02 and 08, a World Championship gold in 2012. He came into PyeongChang just needing the gold medal, and that journey is complete. Just 28 members of the Triple Gold Club, and there he is, the captain, the magic man, Ilya Kovalchuk, or Pavel Datsyuk, rather. Pavel Datsyuk really, really cementing his place in hockey folklore. Just 28 members all time in that Triple Gold Club. Datsyuk's a legend and deserving, and here we go. Oleg Znarek, not often for smiling and laughing, but he will take the gold medal bumps from OAR.
Great scenes for the athletes from Russia. They earned it. But you would equally say, as now Germany are going to come to the middle circle, and are they going to take, yes, their own picture after OAR are going to leave the scene, and they're going to document this moment in time.
Why not? These players all go back to their clubs. They all go back to outside that bubble of being a part of the national team. If you don't get this picture now, you will never get it. You'll skate together forever with this memory, and you want that picture on your wall right next to that silver medal for Team Germany. You talk about personal accomplishments. I don't think Datsyuk will even care about the Triple Gold Club. He'll just be happy that they got the job done. The smile on Datsyuk's face as he went around the corner there was like a kid on Christmas morning.
I think it was a lot of pleasure for the athletes, and the two that are most notable, Kovalchuk and Datsyuk. And while there's a burden of responsibility to deliver a gold medal, and particularly we know how much it means also to Alexander Ovechkin, and he's not with the opportunity that these men have to participate at this Olympic Games tournament, but I think it was a pleasure, but I'm sure they were pretty scared equally.
Germany pushed them to the edge. The fifth Olympics for both Kovalchuk and Datsyuk, and they finally get that. It shows you how hard it is to win a gold medal when two players that good, legends of the sport, took them five tries to wrestle a gold medal away. And it took 9 minutes and 40 seconds of overtime against a German side that were not going away. Germany upset Sweden in the quarterfinals. They upset Canada in the semifinals. They had to play a playoff play positioning game, and it took overtime, a 2-1 win over Switzerland. They had a long road here, but what a road it was for Team Germany. No bigger stage than the Olympic Games, no bigger moment than an Olympic gold medal game in men's ice hockey, no more taxing moment perhaps than overtime, and what an effort it was from the OAR.
They were the team favored to win this tournament, and in the end they did it. It probably didn't go entirely as expected, and they weren't expected to play against the opponent they played against, Germany. Finally get themselves to a gold medal game, they win the best ever medal for themselves, but the best team, OAR, they won.
The Olympic athlete from Russia, they will leave PyeongChang as the gold medalist. Thanks for taking the journey with us. It's been a pleasure.